Championship Saturday is here. Welcome to Boxer Stadium for the CIF San Francisco Academic Athletic Association's Boys Soccer Championship between the number one seed Mission Bears and the number two seed Lowell Cardinals. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. This is Stephen Davies with a welcome, and I am pleased to be joined by today's analyst, Michael Smith, our videographer, Hans Webb, and our producer, Zach Farmer. Once again, you are tuned to CIFSanFrancisco.tv, part of the Play On Sports Network. San Francisco's two top soccer teams are 90 minutes away from deciding the 2012 AAA title. The Bears and the Cardinals have won 44 city championships between them. Both teams have scores to sell out on the pitch today. Second-seeded Lowell are looking for their eighth title in school history and their third consecutive AAA championship. Led by coach Marcos Estevez, the Cardinals have their 48-game unbeaten streak snapped against Mission during the regular season, and they will look to exact revenge on their rivals here at Boxer Stadium this afternoon. Mission are the all-time leading championship-winning team in the San Francisco section, winning the first title all the way back in 1939. And since winning 37 titles, including 8 in the 1970s and 4 in a row in the mid-2000s, but they failed to win the title since 2008-2009. And now with Coach Scott Kennedy at the helm, the Bears have gone undefeated this season, and they look to cap off an undefeated season with a victory here today. Now to bring in our analyst, Michael Smith. Michael, it's a packed house here. A lot of support on hand for both teams, a charged atmosphere, and of course the title on the line. We can't really ask for a lot more than that. What can our fans expect watching this game from these two teams here today?
Well, they're going to expect a lot of hard-nosed competition between two schools that are, like you said, the best in the city of San Francisco when it comes to the sport of soccer. These teams are very familiar with each other. Of course, Lowell, not quite happy that their 48-game unbeaten streak came to an end to these Mission Bears, and since then they've done their best to rebound and show that they're still a very good team to be reckoned with. As for the Mission Bears, like you said, they're undefeated in San Francisco section play. They do have one loss on the season, but that's not really saying much. And that one loss was in their first game against a very good competition, Marin Catholic, one of the best teams in all the Bay Area, if not in Northern California. These Mission Bears, very confident. They play exactly off the personality of their head coach, Scott Kennedy. And I think that's what's propelled them this year to having such great numbers. Of course, they're led by their main goal scorer, which is Marco Caballero. He can do it all. And for Lowell, these guys, you know, their coach, we got to meet him a little bit. And Coach Marco Estevez, man, he's a funny guy. But his team means business. And they will be out here today. And they have some strikers that can get the job done as well. And you talk about Aaron Moy and also Zach Weisenberger. And don't sleep on Fisher. Yeah, he plays the defender role, but head coach Estevez telling us that Fisher will have free range today, and he will move up from the defender if he sees what he likes. He could take it the length of the field and get a goal of his own. So, he feels that his team could really play any kind of ball. They could switch and move pieces around, and whenever you have that kind of depth and that kind of versatility, that's a sign of a great team. So I'm expecting a really good matchup here at Boxer Stadium. The scene is absolutely gorgeous. I mean, we're talking 66 degrees here in the city in the month of November. That's not often. Usually you see overcast day, clouds in the sky. But, I mean, it is a blue sky in front of us, a beautiful Saturday afternoon here in the city of San Francisco. And I can't wait to see who's going to go home with the 2012 AAA Championship Trophy.
Let's give you the starting lineups for both teams. We'll begin with the number one seed Mission Bears. They'll be playing in a 4-4-2 here this afternoon. The goalkeeper, number one, Marcus Lopez. The left back, number three, William Salvador. The right back will be number seven, Christian Cortez. They'll play a sweeper today. They'll be number 10, Irvin Herrera. The central defender will be Alex Sandoval. The midfielders on the left side, Fidel Cesares. In the right side will be Brian Rodriguez. The attacking midfielder will be the aforementioned Marco Caballero. The defensive midfielder, Alder Soto Coronel. And then up front, two strikers, Walter Civilino wearing number 8 and number 11, Marco Ruiz Reyes. Lowell will be playing a 3-5-2 with Abdul Monim in goal. The right back will be Cookie Imperial Salas. The left back will be Elijah Alperin. The central defender will be the captain, number 18, Avery Fisher. They'll play 5 in the midfield. The center midfielder will be the co-captain, number 10, Zachary Weisenberger. The defensive midfielders, number 9, on the left side will be William Slaughterback, and the right side, Ian James. left midfielder will be Antonio Torres. On the right side, Alex Rupert. And then a pair of center forwards on the left side, Peter Harrington. And on the right side, number 19, the junior, Aaron Moy. For Mission, they'll be wearing the Celtic-style yellow hooped jerseys with the white shorts and the white socks. For Lowell, the red and white vertically striped shirts with red shorts and red socks. Mission will go from right to left on your screen, and Lowell from left to right. And as Michael mentioned, it is an absolutely gorgeous afternoon here in San Francisco, just inside the confines of Balboa Park. And we've got an excellent crowd on hand here for this 2012 AAA Championship game as the two teams get ready to take the field here. We'll be keeping score via our cell phones. We don't have a scoreboard here on the field, so we'll try to do our best to keep timing. And we'll cue that up right now as it happens as we get ready to start here the first half of action from Boxer Stadium. And it will be Mission to kick off to start this first half of play. So as mentioned up front then for Mission, the two strikers, Mario Ruiz Reyes and Walter Civilino, will get the proceedings underway here.
Both teams had shaky starts in their semifinal games, but the talent and just the will to win was what propelled the boys to come back in both for both teams' instances and pull off wins. For Lowell, they overcame a 2-0 deficit in their game against their rival Washington and turned that into an 8-3 victory with seven consecutive goals.
Yeah, and Aaron Moy with four of those in that seven goals second half of play.
And as for the Mission Bears, they were down 2-1 with less than 3 minutes left in regulation to San Francisco Institute, and they came back to win 4-2.
Underway then from Boxer Stadium, and a long clearance out to the left side. Underway here in early going, ball goes into touch far side, and it'll be a Lowell throw. A little tricky to identify the numbers here, I feel, Michael, from our vantage point. The black numbers on the Lowell shirts and the yellow numbers on the Mission one. So we'll certainly do our best. Long throw in and takes a bounce off the forward, but I think that's going to be cleared by Cesarez of Mission.
Yeah, I should have bought some binoculars for this one.
I know.
I wasn't aware of the high vantage point we were going to have here at Boxer Stadium. This is the first time I've ever been to this venue. I like this venue, though, even though there's no wayside stands. I like how all the seating is on the home side, and it just has a nice traditional feel to the stadium.
Mission with, or Lowell, excuse me, the attack and play. Ball off a defender. Falls to the center of the field for Weisenberg, and that'll be a missed opportunity there. But a poor clearance from Mission, and they may be able to capitalize here down the right side. Here's the right midfielder, Alex Rupert, in possession here. Right down in the corner, ball goes into touch, and we'll get our first set piece of the afternoon, or corner kick here of the afternoon. And this is, I feel, where this game may boil down to, is the play from set pieces. It'll be Rupert here. He's got players grouped to the far post. Short corner, turned in. Shot deflected away by Mission. That's going to go into touch. And we'll have another corner here for Alex Rupert. And this is an example here of what Michael was saying in the pregame with Avery Fisher, one of the taller players here on this Lowell team, making the move up. Short corner off the crossbar, cleared out the goal mouth. Nicely done by Mission. Cesarez tipped the ball onto the crossbar, came back out into the penalty area and cleared out by Mission. However, I think Cesarez is fouled on the cross there and they'll get a free kick.
Yeah, and that's just a good job of clogging up the goal there by Mission. They had a chance to get that ball to cross in from the corner kick itself, but a good deflection there, a header to get the ball out of the area by Mission. And like I said, just a great job of clearing in what was a kind of a crucial moment early in the game. On the first corner kick try.
Some scrappy play there in the midfield as Mission player was fouled. That was That was the left or the right back, Cortez. And so Mission have their first free kick in the attacking half of the field.
And our producer, Zach Farmer, was telling us we better watch out for a little scrappy play. I mean, these two teams do not like each other.
It's maybe a little too far for Caballero to have a shot. He'll send it in, and that's going to be well wide of the target. It's Caballero's first free kick effort. Goes well wide. And 25, 30 yards is certainly his range. He's scored free kicks from that distance this season. Definitely something to keep an eye on here. Inside third minute of play. And a goal kick sent to the center of the field. Won by Lowell. Now a chance down that left side with Torres. He'll send it in, but easy for Cesares to handle. The ball goes over the goal line for a goal kick.
And right now, head coach Kennedy asking both his players and I believe the refs who's got 10, but I think he's really talking to his players as Weisenberg just seems to be all over the field right now trying to create as much chances as he can for his Lowell Cardinal team.
Opportunity here for Harrington. Oh, great ball. Chance for Lowell to take a shot on goal, and it's turned away. Nice defending over there on the far side by Cookie Imperial Sales, but Lowell win the ball back, and it's still very much on the attack here. Some frantic clearing there from Mission, but good play there by Harrington, picking out a man in space over the left side. And they'll have their third corner kick now within the first 5 minutes.
The Lowell Cardinals, so far, their offense is looking a little bit better than the Mission, than the Bears of Mission, creating a little bit more chances. This is now going to be their second corner kick.
Sent in, punched out nicely by Cesares. Lowell will have the ball here. Here's Ian James, shakes off a player, sends it up forward, and that's going to be offside. James just a little bit too hasty with that pass into the center. Cleared out by Cesares. One on the turn. Cleared out there by the central defender, Avery Fisher. He sends that into touch on the far side. About 5 minutes in here, no score. Maybe a little bit of nerves from both teams here in the early going, but Lowell a little bit of the brightest start so far. Ball into touch, both teams want it. It'll go in the favor of Lowell. Well inside the defensive half of the field. Long throw in once again. Back off a defender, and this is Harrington hustling down that left side. A little bit too much on that. A little bit too much on the ball there. He does get fouled over there on the far side. And a free kick coming up here for Lowell.
And over there on to what you guys are seeing on your screen would be the top right of the screen is the only area on this field where there is shade from one of the big trees. So that might be a spot on the field that might cause difficulty. I mean, pretty much you have, 97% of this field, maybe 95% of this field sunny. And then you just have that one top corner that's kind of shady. Might play a trick on the eyes of what to look for as far as trying to cross that ball into more of the middle of the field for more of a better of a scoring chance.
Three men in the wall here for Mission. Five Lowell players in the box. Left foot boot from Harrington. Good ball in. Cleared nicely by Mission. Right in front for Lowell. Chance in front. Turning and making a fine save. Diving to his right with Cesares. Under pressure
Marcos
there.
Marcos Lopez actually the goalkeeper there. And yeah, he did really do a good job coming up and making the stop.
Lowell once
Marcos
again.
Marcos Lopez has just been brilliant this whole season as the goalkeeper for for the Mission Bears.
And he's forced to make another save there. Down to the knees to reel that one in. Much brighter start, though, from Lowell so far.
It was Lopez who had six saves in a game earlier this year. I believe his six saves came against against International back on August 27th.
Again, ball loose in the area, but Lopez is right there, and he's been very busy in the early going. And this is what Coach Kennedy kind of warned us about, was a sluggish start. We saw it against SFI with a trail by 2 goals. Ball out of bounds here near side. And I think so far, it's fair to say, it's been a little bit of a sluggish start here as well for the Bears. Now they'll get a throw in here on the left side. Fidel Cesarez to take it. We're at number 17. 5 players in the box here. No one got in that far post there for Lowell. And a substitution made here as Brian Rodriguez comes off. He's replaced by Jonathan Ochoa. Ochoa wearing number 15. Will take his place on the edge of the 18-yard box. Here's a throw in from Cazares. It's a good one. Floats into the area. Cleared out by Lowell. And now they have a chance on the counterattack here with Harrington down the right side. Turning on the Jets. And a nice shoulder charge there by Alex Sandoval. And he did well there to slow down Harrington and send the ball back downfield. No one home, however, for Mission. They'll try and create something here on the right side. He's battling for it here in the midfield. One by Cortez. And a foul here as Harrington collides with a Mission player. And that was with, I believe, with Marco Caballero. So he gets fouled just inside the attacking half of the field here for Mission. About 11 minutes or so into this game. And a free kick coming up for Mission. Players congregated to that right side of the penalty area. Irvin Herrera to float it in to the far post. That's going to be kept in. Plays Ballinford in front. Goalkeeper came out. Still bouncing around inside the area. Shot on goal is well wide of the target. That fell to Cortez there, but his shot is well wide. It'll be a goal kick here for Lowell. A little bit of a nervous moment there for Monim. The ball went to that far side. Monim came out. Ball was headed back into the center of the center of the 6-yard box, and Monim could have been caught out. Luckily, his defenders were right there. So Avery Fisher will handle the goal kicking duties here for the Cardinals. No score here from Boxer Stadium inside the first 15 minutes of play. Turning on the far side, there was Torres. Loses possession. Right back to Mission. Chest down well there. Good ball into the center. And a mix up in defense here. Mission with an opportunity. Shot on goal is wide of the target.
So Mission has started to, in the last 5 minutes or last 2 minutes, 3 minutes or so, they've really started to up their offensive chances here, starting to take a little bit more risks, getting that ball into the zone. I'd like to see them keep the ball in that offensive attacking zone just a little bit longer. Seems like they just give it up so quickly to Lowell, and it seems like Lowell's been on the attack a little bit more than Mission tonight, this afternoon.
Midfield play from both teams really has been less than stellar at this point, but Lowell so far have made better chance of their, or better usage of their opportunities so far. And this is a good place for them here for the throw-in.
Seems like Lowell's had a lot more team speed today as well. I don't know if Mission having to use all their energy in that comeback win in the semifinals, if they're a little lethargic and are out, but it just seems as if Lowell's a little bit more conditioned for today's match so far.
Here's a potential breakaway opportunity now for Mission. Spreading the field nicely here, but that's a poor pass. Cleared by Lowell.
Yeah, he should have kept it himself and kept going. He could have had a chance for a breakaway.
It's been the story of this game so far. It's been the midfield battles here. Nice passing play here by Lowell down the right side. Good play by Luis Batista, and he's well in the clear down the right side. Looking for a cross into the middle. Good ball. Put the goalkeeper off the crossbar. Off the back of the bar, he tried to float that one over Lopez. And almost got away with a cheeky first goal that did Lowell.
Yeah, they put one up high. And it was just a little too high. Luckily, the crossbar there saved that one from going in.
Well, I think that was
a matter of inches.
Yeah, I think that was a cross that went awry there, but it almost caught Marcus Lopez out of position. goal kick mission here. Not the greatest one, and Lowell quick to hustle to the ball. They have it in possession here with Batista once again. Numbers in the midfield here. A little bit too much weight on that pass from Lowell, and it's scooped up easily by Lopez. Good boot downfield by Lopez, defending, or cleared, I should say, by Lowell. They have the ball down the right side. Batista gets a shoulder charge in there from Salvador, the right back.
And bouncing up off the turf there for Lowell, number 19, Aaron Moy, shaking his hand. Might have got his hand stepped on while he was down on the ground after two players collided him in a mission bear.
Some physical play there for sure, and Harrington will take a free kick here from the right side. Avery Fisher, one of the players to watch here on these set pieces. He's wearing number 18. Low kick in from Harrington, not his best. That might have come off the hand of the mission defender, unseen by the referee, and they'll clear out down this left side. Oh, good ball ahead. Putting pressure on the Lowell defense, and they do well to clear. Mission in possession, left side. Number 17, Cesarez. Pass to his teammate, Christian Cortez. I like what I've seen of Christian Cortez so far, coming up from defense to make things happen in midfield. What these two teams need at the moment. Free kick taken then by Mission, Irvin Herrera. He'll be looking for his target man, Caballero, here in the box. 16 minutes or so into this 2012 San Francisco Section AA Championship game. Mission and Lowell mixing it up on a beautiful Saturday afternoon here at Boxer Stadium in Balboa Park. It's Herrera to take the free kick. And again, hooks that well wide of the target. Would like to have done a lot better on that free kick there, I think, Michael.
Yeah, I think so. He was he definitely seemed that maybe didn't connect off the side of the toe or the boot that he was looking for. He just misfired on that one, and there will be some more chances. This game, like I said, still relatively fresh.
Alex Rupert out on the field to replace number 7, Antonio Torres. Battling down here near side and well won. Nice effort there by Mario Meja to win the ball. And Mission get another throw in. They've had these opportunities now, especially on the left side. They seem to be finding some space at the moment, but
it's just their crosses into the middle have not been all that spectacular. Really been inaccurate with their passing into the middle.
Gazzara's long throw in. Goes through the Lowell defense. Nice turn. Shot on goal is into the side netting. Good look in front there for Mission. And that was Civilino with the shot. Tight angle, though, as Monim did well to close him down. And he puts that right into the side of the goal. The first real opportunity today for either team on goal. Mission just wide of the target. And they've certainly picked it up a little bit over these last 5 minutes. Good clearance, however, here by Lowell. And a chance to bring the ball down the left wing. Waiting for numbers for some support in the center. Good ball outside. Nicely done to pick out his target man there, Luis Batista. But Batista's shot goes almost into the Balboa Park BART station, as he sends that well wide. So far, Bautista's certainly presenting cause for concern for this Mission defense. Finding space over on the right side. Another substitution, or a couple of substitutions here for Mission. On comes Hugo Wanderley de Souza and Mario Ruiz Reyes to replace Kevin Ochoa and Fidel Cesarez. Goal kick, again won by Lowell. Turned over quickly. And now an opportunity for Mission to capitalize once again down the left side. Mario Ruiz Reyes, he gets dispossessed. Nicely done. It's Bautista again. Bautista with players giving chase. Ball into the center of the field. Takes a deflection off a Mission defender. And it's just rushing it a little bit. He's creating chances here for Lowell, but Bautista's touch deserts him a little bit.
Yeah, he has to let the player let the play kind of develop, wait for his other teammates to get around the area, and then feed him.
Lowell scrambling a little bit here on defense. Had to send the ball into touch, and this is a dangerous position here for Mission to send in the ball. Ball into the center here. Oh, nice turn. Some more frantic Lowell defending there, and that'll be a corner kick here for Mission, their first of the day coming up. It'll be taken by Mario Meja. We're at number 23.
And Mario Mejia, another guy that could score goals for this Mission team. It's not all Caballero.
So they will make some substitutions here just before this corner kick is taken. Adel Cesares wasn't on the bench for long. As he comes out on the field to replace Mario Reyes. It's a quick breather there for Cesares, and he'll take his position up at the far post. No one here on the near post for Mission. As they move in now. Decent corner. Cleared nicely by Lowell. Headed out by Harrington. But Mission back in possession. That's a good ball to the outside. Looking for a player in the center skipping over a defender. And it looks like an offside here against Mission. It'll be a free kick to Lowell. And even though we're about 20 minutes in here, Michael, neither team has really shown signs of settling down here yet.
Yeah, I think for Lowell, you brought it up. I think their attacking wings have just really tried to do too much on their own. Really haven't looked for any of their other teammates across the middle of the field to try to pass the ball to and create opportunities. And for Mission, they have done a really good job of getting the ball into Lowell of late. To start, they seem like they couldn't find that other half of the field for the first 5 minutes. But ever since they put on a lot of pressure, the only problem is maybe they're trying to do a little bit too much juke moves and whatnot as Lowell has been able to take the ball away from them quite a bit here in this first half.
And we saw that just now on this on the play right before this free kick with a Lowell player trying to acute back heel there, but it worked out in their favor as they get the free kick. However, it's a poor one. And Mission will clear. They find space on the right side. Searching ball downfield, looking for the forward, but unable to find it. Ball goes into touch. Wholesale substitutions here in the early going for both teams. And another one coming up here for Lowell as Aaron Moy, who had taken a quick break there, relieves Luis Hernandez. So no score here from Boxer Stadium, about 20 minutes in. Once again, there's no scoreboard on the field, so we are keeping time up here in the booth. So we're about, as we said, about 20 minutes in. Throwing cleared by Mission into touch. And a good position here now for Lowell to capitalize and perhaps score the first goal of this game. Thrown to the edge of the penalty area, turned nicely by Lowell. Passing the space in the middle. Sending that back now to Harrington. He was looking for his right winger there. It's Alexander Rupert here, right side. But defended nicely by Mission. Fidel Cazares sending that one into touch.
Yeah, this is where you'd like to see a goal happen. I don't know if you really want to go into half with a scoreless tie. Someone's got to jump out and get this. Talking to Coach Estevez before the game, and when I asked him his team will win the championship if, he said score goals, and I kind of laughed. I thought that was a simple answer, but it's the truth. Someone's got to strike first.
But I think overall you have to be pleased with the way Lowell have defended so far.
Yeah.
Their defense is certainly organized, and they've had chances up front, but just haven't been able to take them so far. So,
yeah, I've been really happy with their defense. Very quick.
Good moves here. A nice step over there. Juking between players. That was Aaron Moy. Mission defense stout. And they find space on the right side to clear.
I was going to say, equally as impressive has been Mission's defense so far today. As they have done just enough to prevent any goals from going in on their own right. They have gotten in front of a couple corner kicks from Lowell today. And they've made sure that when you think that ball is going to get there, just at the last minute, either someone's stepped in front and kind of kicked the ball away, or, of course, their goalkeeper, Marcos Lopez, a senior here, he's looked fantastic today. He has about a handful of saves.
Yeah, and to think that Lowell had Mission really pressed in that early going with, I think, two or three corner kicks. They've really been struggling for chances. About 23 minutes in now. That's been kind of the story of the day there. Not really under a lot of pressure there in the midfield. And not the best first touch. Goes out of bounds, and it's a Mission throw. I think that's where this game may come down to, is which midfield can sort themselves out first. And in that regard, so far, it's been a pretty even match. The best chance coming about 5 minutes ago is Walter Siviano sent a shot into the side netting from about 8 or 9 yards out. Free kick then for Mission, sent into the box. Dangerous-looking ball. Goalkeeper's going to have to come out. He misses a punch. It's going to be cleared away by Lowell. There's a foul, though, and one of the Lowell defenders fouled in the skirmish there in the penalty area. They got away with one there, Michael, as Monim came off his line trying to punch the ball away.
Yeah, Monim did jump out and take a risk, and but he flashed that, hey, thanks a lot, brother. Kind of a hand symbol to his teammates for having his back and really playing some good defense, getting behind him and not allowing that goal to get through.
Rupert's cross in the box fielded by Lopez, and he's sensing an opportunity quickly, hustles the ball downfield.
Lopez has just had some magnificent kicks.
Yeah, he's really buying him some space here, and an offside, and, well, that's too bad for Mission, because Lopez was on his horse quickly there. Noticing they had a numbers advantage downfield. But a Mission forward offside there, right on the edge of the 18-yard box. And it'll be a free kick to Lowell. Nice turnover on the far side. Here comes Lowell down the left wing. Ball into the center. A little bit too much on that one. Let's clear it out. That's a nice play there by the Mission midfielder.
Chip pass sailing a bit too far, taking a couple bounces out.
Yeah, Caballero there stepping in front of a player. Won the ball nicely, but really rushed the pass, trying to be a little too fancy perhaps with the setup play for the striker. Ball goes over the goal line. Still no score here from Boxer Stadium. Midway through this first half of play. Be a goal kick now for Lowell and Avery Fisher to handle the duties here. Stephen Davies, Michael Smith, Hans Webb, Zach Farmer from Boxer Stadium for the 2012 San Francisco section title game. Now, here come Lowell down the right side. Bautista's shoulder charge out of the way. Good defensive play there, but turned over quickly. Back comes Bautista. Ball out of bounds. Credit to Lowell. That was sticking with the attack. And they're credited here for their resilience with the corner.
Yeah, and Mission doing, I've noticed a lot of the times when they feel they're in danger, having to play some good defense in their own part of the field. They've used the hard-hitting checks to bounce balls away from Lowell attackers.
Corner kick cleared by Mission, but sent back into the box, turning and not able to get there in time. It was the Lowell forward.
And I know one of those checks I saw earlier in the game really frustrated Harrington here on the near side, and I think if Mission continues to keep checking into the attackers in order to steal the ball away, eventually it might get chippy. We might see some cards issued. Luckily, we haven't seen any yellow or red cards so far in this first half, but those take a while to brew up.
Here come Lowell once again. A long-range shot won't trouble Lopez. He goes to his knees to reel that one in. And you get the feeling that's just perhaps they take that extra step or so here. Really make a difference in this game. That was really a rushed opportunity as Lowell had an advantage there numbers-wise, but unable to capitalize. Scrappy play again here in the midfield. Caballero will look for a play downfield.
And just in that pass sequence alone, I saw about three Mission Bear defenders kind of slip on the turf here, lose footing, and essentially it knocked away what would have been good opportunities to maybe, get the ball into the middle of the field and give it to someone who could be on the attack and maybe pose a breakaway threat.
Rodriguez did well to win possession here close to the touchline. Foul down the right side. Caballero mixing it up there with Avery Fisher. Ball goes over the goal line, though. Have a couple of substitutions here as we've reached about the 30-minute mark. Still no score here from Boxer Stadium. On comes Luis Bautista, wearing number 25. As does Ian James back in the game. Lowell in possession here, right side. That's what we've seen a lot of today. A lot of poor first touches. Not a lot of sustained possession in the midfield. Now Lowell, nice moves here down the right side. This is a good run from Slaughterback. Good ball into the center. The head is just wide of the target. Tremendous cross in there from William Slaughterback. Looking for his forward there, and the header was on target, but just wide of the post.
Yeah, and that's the loudest the crowd's gotten all day today, yeah. Steven. They really thought that they had a good opportunity to score, and they did. I mean, it was a beautiful cross put on by Slaughterback.
Goal kick falls to Lowell. Mission player to the ground. And having a little trouble clearing now a mission. And Lowell in the last 5 minutes has really started to string some offensive play together. Long range shot is handled nicely by Lopez. Took a tough hop right in front of him. But Lopez showing the safe hands will clear for mission. Play is battling down here, near side. Ball into touch. Be a Lowell throw. Peter Harrington will come back in for Lowell. He will replace Luis Hernandez. And that was the best opportunity of the day by far for Lowell. An excellent Slaughterback cross. He did well to make something happen there on that right side. And headed just wide. Be a Lowell throw, just inside the attacking half of the field. Looking downfield for Harrington again has turned the defender. And that mission player, looked like Justice Molina had to come in there to clear. It'll be a corner kick again. Looks like Harrington will take it. Lowell with six players in the box, all to that far side. Left-footed cross, comes in, header on target, it's there! A goal for Lowell. And let's see the scorer.
I think that's number 10, Zachary Weisenberger with the goal.
Unmarked at the near post, Weisenberger's header, a bullet into the back of the net. Lowell take the lead.
And now he's flashing up his jersey to make sure that we know it's number 10. Zachary Weisenberger with a great header there to get the goal. Getting some love and adulation from his teammates.
That'll be worrying for Mission because Weisenberger was lurking at the far post. Took the header from about 7 or 8 yards out. A powerful header right into the top of the net. Nothing Lopez could have done about that one. And Lowell have the lead thanks to the captain. Now, how will the Bears respond? They were thrown far side. Turning, oh, making a nice turn there between defenders. Was Meja. The ball goes across the goal line for a Lowell goal kick. I had a feeling, as we mentioned in the pregame, that this would be a game that would come down to those set pieces. Harrington's had plenty of opportunities now with his corner kicks. I think it was about the fifth or sixth that Lowell have had this afternoon. And an unmarked Zachary Weisenberger has a bullet into the back of the net. 1-0 the score. Lowell with the lead.
And in a game with two great teams such as these squads today, like I said, I think drawing blood first is the biggest key. And Lowell's able to do that.
Here come Lowell again looking for Harrington downfield. Cleared by Mission, but they're still scrambling around. Dancing around far side. One off the Mission player. Cross into the box. Turned away by Lopez. Cleared by Mission. Suddenly, things looking a little nervous at the back for Mission. And here's Caballero clearing. Doing well. Pass into the center. He just got his foot almost caught in the turf there as he tried to pass into the middle. But thanks to his effort here, Caballero is still in possession. Does well to send the ball out right side. Lower player steps in front to clear. That was Luis Hernandez. It'll be a throw in for Mission.
Luis Hernandez, only a sophomore. Really good job of just stepping out front of that pass. Saw that it didn't have enough mustard on it. Rolled rather slowly. Just kicked it away. And Luis Hernandez, one of a bevy of sophomores on this Lowell High School squad. I mean, this is a very young squad that should be set up well for the future.
Yeah, 12 sophomores on this Lowell team. Another Mission attack. Runs out of juice. Luckily, they'll get a throw in here near side. Trailing by a goal now thanks to Zachary Weisenberger's header from 8 yards out. The difference in this game is Lowell lead, 1-0. Here's a throw-in. Again, no one home for Mission. He's watching that one come in. However, Lowell not done a good job here of clearing. And they're still trying to find a way to get the ball out. Player turns and misses. Chance from distance. It is bobbled by Monim. He's going to have to get there quick. Player fouled in the box. That could be a penalty. No, Monim is hurt. I think he took a knee to the head there as he tried to dive in front of the Mission attacker.
I think their heads both collided.
Yeah.
Is what happened.
That was a nasty looking
even
collision.
Mission, the Mission Bear attacker out there, he's hanging on, holding on to his head. I believe that's number 23, Mario Mejia, getting tangled up with the goalie for Lowell, Abdulmobdi Monim.
Yeah, that play came from nothing there. It was a
and Mejia still holding on to his head. He's down to a knee now in front of the box.
They've got a second goalkeeper warming up here, and yeah, Monim went down quickly. He did well to get in front of Mejia that time.
And so an injury timeout, although the clock is still running, so this will be stoppage time that will be added on to the end of the game.
We'll see if our producer Zach Farmer can get an idea of the amount of added time here at the end of the first half, but you've got to say at least it'll be a few minutes, 2 or 3 minutes at least. Both coaching staffs out onto the field. Coach Estevez is over to tend to his goalkeeper. So a shot from about 20 yards out there was difficult for Monim to handle. He bobbled the ball.
And Mejia.
Ball fell back for him.
Yeah, Mejia back and on his feet. And it was just an interesting situation. You saw that kind of back and forth volley, almost like a volleyball, if you will. The ball just going from head to head, not really bouncing on the turf. It finally did bounce on the turf. And Mission was the first to really grab the ball and attack it. And they kicked a nice little line drive shot at Monim. He couldn't make the first save. The ball deflected on him, was still rolling around him, and that's when Mejia took it into his own hands to try to, you know, score off the deflection. And in running into the goalkeeper, they both collided with their heads. And it seems as if Monim might be leaving the field of play.
Yeah, he is.
I don't know if he's going to be making a comeback at all, but we do have a new goalie in a green long sleeve shirt now for Lowell.
Aiden Powers Riggs will come on to replace Monim. And
another sophomore.
Luckily for Lowell on that effort by Mission, they had two defenders back there behind Monim, and they were able just to clear before the ball would have reached the mouth of the goal. But Monim definitely giving up the body there to make the save, to say the least, on Mejia. But I think more worrisome for Lowell there was the poor defensive clearing effort they had.
Yeah.
They want to get things together quickly here. They have the lead, don't forget, but Mission now perhaps sensing an opportunity to try and get back into this game. There's another questionable Lowell clearance. Mission have the ball. It's a nice pass here left side. See if Mission can make something happen here in the corner. Doing well to shrug off a player. That was Kevin Ochoa. Sends that one in. Oh, fine save. Now, did the ball go over the line? They're going to say no. Tremendous save from Powers Riggs. He had 1 foot back over the goal line, but was able to keep the ball ahead of the line.
And that's all that matters in this game. As long as the ball isn't across, it doesn't matter if his feet are behind the line.
Hernandez shakes off a player. Sends the ball in. Lopez does well, diving backwards to turn that one away. Wow, Lowell on the counterattack now. And this game has really opened up in this last minute of play.
A great job by Lopez. He had lost focus as far as he wasn't in good position to make the stop on that. And then he made kind of an awkward jump back to deflect the ball away.
Luckily, his defense is right there to help him clear the ball out. The tempo of this game has picked up considerably since Monim went off injured. And both goalkeepers now have had to make fine saves within the last couple minutes of play. It's going to be a throw into Lowell far side. 1-0, the Lowell lead. Zachary Weisenberger with a header to score the only goal of the day so far. But both teams now have really started to pick things up here. An entertaining series of play from both teams here. Mission in possession, far side. About 40 minutes or so in. We'll try and get a signal when we've reached the 45-minute mark. We'll probably have, I would think, at least 2 or 3 minutes of added time here in the first period because of the injury to the sophomore goalkeeper, Abdul Monim. So free kick here for Mission from the right side. And they'll have seven players in the box. And it's a poor free kick. It'll be cleared by Lowell. Harrington has it in the middle, defended by Mission. The ball falls to the lower midfielder, who sends it all the way back down to Marcos Lopez.
Marcos Lopez taking some time for things to develop, but he had all his players. I would have just kicked it as far as I can.
And missed opportunity to clear here by Mission, and Lowell have it on the left side. Two players in support in the middle. Midfield. Oh, good save. Lopez diving. Cleared by Mission. Nicely done. Lowell had two players in the box, but the winger wasn't able to find the target, and that's a nice defensive play there by Ian James to win the ball and send it downfield for Harrington. Harrington tries to turn off his defender. Back to the center of the field, looking for an open play. He was looking for Hernandez. He shoulder charged off the ball, and a nice back heel there to maintain possession for Mission.
I think it's Walter Seviano coming up limping there, absorbing the contact.
And a substitution here is Harrington is going to take a quick break. He's going to be replaced by Antonio Torres. Yeah, Harrington took a little bit of a blow there at the end of that previous Lowell possession. Thrown in Lowell far side. False submission, cleared. The center of the field. James is right there. He's looking for play right side. And cleared out by Mario Ruiz Reyes. So it's a Lowell throw. Waning moments now this first half of play. It's a Lowell lead, 1-0. Zachary Weisenberger, the scorer. Another quick substitution here. As Bautista replaces Alexander Rupert.
Watching the Muni train go by here by Boxer Stadium, and that's...
Ball falls to the middle of the field there. It's cleared out by Mission. That was a good opportunity for Lowell. Just one man there in the center. But the first touch wasn't the best one. And Mission were able to clear. Now they find some space down this left side. Nice job by the attacker there. The shoulder charge man out of the way. Making a cross in the center. Cleared out. Ooh, that took a wicked deflection there. The spin fell for Lowell. They do well to clear it the second attempt.
And the Lowell fans showing their appreciation there.
Yeah, Silviano making things happen on that left side for Mission.
Lowell's defense really stepped up that time.
Yeah. It's a ball sent downfield for a Lowell throw well inside the attacking third of the field. This will be taken by Aaron Moy. Moy, good long throw into the box. Headed back. Chance in front. Over the top of the crossbar. Wow. Good effort there by Lowell. And they almost caught Lopez flat-footed. But that's going to do it. The end of the first half. Lowell lead this game 1-0 on the headed goal by Zach Weisenberger. We'll go to the halftime. And we'll be back with you in just a few minutes here on CIF. SanFrancisco.tv, part of the Play On Sports Network.
one match away from immortality.
This is a total team effort.
We're gonna come at you.
One shot.
One match away from immortality.
This is a total team effort.
We're gonna come at you.
One shot.
Start the stream.
Camera three.
Beautiful. Oh, we're coming in on one.
For more information on how your school can join the Play On School broadcast program, go to playonsports.com/SBP.
Welcome back to the CIF San Francisco.tv halftime show. Stephen Davies here with Michael Smith, Hans Webb providing our video coverage, and Zach Farmer behind the controls. Here from Boxer Stadium in the beautiful Balboa Park district of the great city of San Francisco. Michael, entertaining first half. Still think both teams a little bit on the nervous side, though. However, it's Lowell with the 31st-minute goal by Zachary Weisenberger, the difference in this game so far.
Yeah, and it was a beautiful goal. They had an opportunity for a corner kick there, and they made, you know, they've had some really good corner kicks so far. They've definitely had the advantage in drawing more corner kicks than Mission has today, and they took a lot of chances in the first half, and there was just some great defense set up by Mission, and also some a lot of great saves by their goalkeeper Marcos Lopez. But on the most important one, the one that scored the goal, it was just probably the best cross of them all, only where one man can get it, and that was Weisenberger. Hit it right off the temple and yep. Deflected it into the goal. And it looked like the way he was going to deflect it, it was going to shoot more to the left side of the post. And I think that's what caught Lopez off guard. He was ready to make his move to his right, but instead the deflection where it caught off the head just narrowly got inside the right side of the goal post. And Lopez couldn't react in time to make the stop there. And it was just a nice header by Zachary. And then, of course, he did show at the end, his number, lifting up his jersey, doing his sort of celebration there.
I think he did that for us so we could actually see who scored, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
It has been a little tricky for us to identify the players' numbers. We're certainly doing our best. However, in Lopez's defense, I don't even think Ikea Casillas could have stopped that header from Mr. Weisenberger. 31st-minute goal, and the header from Zachary Weisenberger, the difference here, giving Lowell the lead. The other big story of the first half was a collision in front of goal between Mario Mejia and the sophomore goalkeeper for Lowell, Abdul Monim. Monim unfortunately had to leave the game. Looked like a somewhat fairly nasty collision down there right in front of the goal.
Yeah, I mean, you talk about another header, only this time it was two heads colliding with both Monim for Lowell and Mejia of Mission. And Mejia was down, but eventually got up on his own power and walked off and was still able to finish out the rest of the first half, where for Monim, he was it took him a little bit longer to get up, and he had to be escorted by his head coach and trainer, and then he never returned for the last final minutes of the first half. So we'll see if Monim was just a little shaken up and will come back to start at goalkeeper for the second half, or if it will be the backup, which is Aiden Powers-Riggs, to finish out this AAA San Francisco City Championship for boys soccer. And interesting to note, it was Mission who had a 1-0 lead in the game earlier this season, and then they went on to win. So Lowell now with the 1-0 lead this go-around, maybe that's a good sign that they might pull off the win. Remember, I told you in the first half that I felt the biggest key was striking first. Lowell able to do that, and we'll see if they can just do the necessary things to keep on to the lead, which is going to be good defense and just keeping that ball inside the Mission, in their attacking zone. And they've really done a good job at Lowell of taking chances away from Mission. Just when Mission seems to get something set up, a good pass towards an attacking midfielder, Lowell just seems to step out in front of every pass, contest every pass, and then clear it out. Meanwhile, Mission has done a good job defensively. They started to pick it up with their offensive chances, but really haven't quite gotten a good boot on a ball yet.
I've been impressed with the play of Walter Civilino, wearing number 8 there for Mission. He's definitely had some opportunities down the left side, and I think that's where Mission need to exploit this Lowell defense in the second half. They maybe got a little bit too, what's the word I'm looking for, a little bit too relaxed perhaps, trying to clear the ball, and on the play where the goalkeeper Monim was injured, it was fortunate for him that he had two of his defenders there back there to help him clear the ball. What would have been perhaps Lowell's, or Mission's, excuse me, best opportunity to score thus far. Civilino also rifled a shot into the side netting from about 8 yards out, about 15 minutes or so into that first half of play. So the teams will switch ends in for the second half. It will be Mission going from from left to right. They're wearing the Celtic-style hoop jerseys, yellow and white, white shorts and white socks. Lowell in the vertically striped red and white jerseys with the red shorts and the red socks. Again,
and Mission's going to have to get their headliner involved in this game. Haven't called a lot of Marco Caballero's name yet today.
Good point.
And he's the guy that kind of gets this whole Mission Bears team going.
Well, I think one of the reasons behind that is Lowell having five men in the midfield. They've got an extra player.
Yeah, they switched their defense up from the traditional 4-4-2 and rolled with a 3-5-2 to prevent Caballero from really going off. Coach Estevez, who was the coach of the year last year in the San Francisco City section, and he's showing why in the early stages of this championship game. You know, he's no dummy. He definitely learned what went wrong for his team in the game that they played earlier this year, and has really came out with a great game plan to try to stop what Mission can do. And so far, he's been successful in shutting them out in the first half.
And star players for Lowell in the first half. Harrington, I thought, had an excellent first half, as is Luis Batista, making things happen on the right side. It'll be interesting to see if we'll see a little bit more of Aaron Moy and William Slaughterback. He's the one that sent a good-looking cross into the area. A shot turned away by Lopez midway through that first half of play. Back underway then to begin the second half of play is Lowell to kick off. And they might have an opportunity here in the early going. Left side, player in possession is number 7, Antonio Torres. He does well to shake free of a couple players, but the ball rolls into touch, and it'll be a Mission throw. So first minute of action then, second period of play. Lowell leading this game 1-0. Long throw in, fielded by a Lowell player, and well, we don't need to tell you where that hit him. He's okay. That's Peter Harrington there, or Zachary Weisenberg, excuse me. Another throw in, however, for Mission. Collision here in the midfield. Foul against Lowell, against Lowell, excuse me. So it'll be Lowell free kick just inside of their own half of the field. Taken here by Avery Fisher. Ball sent into the penalty area. Headed out by Mission into touch for another Lowell throw. So inside the first few minutes here of the second half. And a beautiful afternoon here at Boxer Stadium for this 2012 championship game. Throw in by Lowell. Be fielded easily by Lopez. So it's Powers Riggs remaining in the game, a goalkeeper for Lowell. And he had to make a big save towards the end of that first period of play to preserve this 1-0 lead that Lowell currently enjoy. Now, opportunity for Mission far side, and that should be a card. A body check there, and really an unnecessary play. And we'll have our first card of the day issued to Mission for a hip check on the lower midfielder there. And that's going to be on Mario Ruiz Reyes, and he's substituted by Fidel Cazares. So free kick Lowell. And really what's been a pretty evenly tempered match so far results in an unnecessary yellow card there for Ruiz Reyes. So free kick then for Lowell. It's a good one into the box, out of the range of Harrington, cleared by Mission. That's one thing they've done well today, is not panicking. The ball comes into the area. And the ball will go over the goal line. And a goal kick for the Bears. This will be taken by Irvin Herrera, the sweeper. Lowell in possession in the midfield. Good ball, nice turn there by Torres, but the ball out of bounds, and a throw for Mission. We'd like to see Mission pick up the tempo here. A little bit of a lethargic start to the second half. Something, as we mentioned, Coach Kennedy warned about. It was a sluggish start. They saw it against SFI in the semifinal. And the same here today. Now, attacking opportunity down the left side is snuffed out by the Lowell defense. However, it will be a corner kick. Now let's see if Mission can make something happen here with their first corner kick of the second half of play. Remember the first goal of the day scored on a set piece by Zachary Weisenberger. Can Mission repeat the feat here? We'll have seven players in the box. It's a good corner kick in. Chance here in front of goal for Mission. It's cleared nicely by Lowell, but another corner kick coming up. Play was free there at the back post for Mission. Ball fell to him nicely. It was a great corner kick. But Mission unable to capitalize. They'll get a second opportunity, though, this time from the other side. Be an in-swinging corner kick here. Left footer to take it. Sends it into the near post and into the side netting for a goal kick for Lowell. Headed there by Torres. Oh, falls nicely here for Lowell. They've got a chance here. Harrington making a run into the center, cleared out by Mission. Battling play there by William Slaughter back there alongside Hugo Wanderlei D'Souza, but ball goes in favor of Mission. About 6 minutes into the second period of play. Again, no scoreboard here at Boxer Stadium, so we're keeping time up here in the booth. We'll do our best to keep on time with the officials. Mission to send the ball downfield, trying to find some space over that left side, but the Lowell defense has been organized so far in the second half. They win possession once again. Good battling effort there by the right back. Send the ball down the field. Now Lowell able to break away here. Harrington lurking in the center of the field. The attacker does well to step around a defender. It's cleared by Mission. Ball won by James there in the midfield. Loses possession, however. Mission ball. Now Mission plays to each side here. Another poor pass there, and Lowell defense steps in front of it. And out of bounds into touch. Michael, your thoughts on the second half so far?
Yeah, it's just it's been a lot of poor passing so far from both teams. A near goal there by Mission, missing just left of the goalpost.
Yeah, shot that wouldn't really have given Powers Riggs too much concern. However, I'm liking the fact that both teams are not just relying on running the ball right up the center of the field, using the space on both sides to send the ball into the middle.
Well, I think Mission, I don't know, they just... It's not by choice that they've gotten any balls in the middle. It's just they haven't been able to do so. Lowell has really plugged that middle ground up.
It's a good defensive effort there by Samuel Villarreal there to clear the ball. It'll be a Lowell throw, however.
Harrington. Lowell, just their passes have been a little bit more crisp and on the money.
Yeah.
They've really been able to get that ball out of their defensive zone.
So it's a throw-in now for Antonio Torres on the left side. Heads into the center, cleared out by Mission. Deflection off a Lowell player into touch. Mission throw. Fans cheering on both sets of teams here. Ball falls to Harrington. Pua first touch. Turn over to Mission. Battling with it down here on the left side. Byron Rivera turns over. This has not been a pretty game to watch in midfield for either team really today as they send the ball out to the left side. How can Lowell make something happen here with the ball? And just as I say that, they give it away, and it's been the story of the afternoon. So here's Slaughter back in the midfield, out to Harrington, far side. Loses possession. Slaughter back will get a second opportunity there as James sends it out left. Players get the legs tangled there. Ball sent into touch. Mission throw.
One thing I have noticed here in the second half is Coach Kennedy for Mission taking a seat. He was on his feet the whole first half, yelling out instructions to his players. Very vocal, very animated. And there he goes. Can't stay seated for too long. He's back up on his feet now, getting players ready to come off the bench and onto the field.
Well, at this point, it's which team wants it more. And
well, remember he said that was his goal of the game. We talked about Coach Estevez's, how his team was going to win the game. He gave us the very easy, simple answer of we got to score goals, where for Coach Kennedy, he gave us the answer of who wants it more, and right now his team has not shown that they wanted it more. But I'll tell you, Lowell's made it very difficult for them to want it more. As Lowell's just been at the right place, right time. Like I said, it's really plugged up the middle of the field. Has not given any of the middle field to Mission to work with.
Torres, after a nice control, goes out of bounds. He's substituted, I should say. It was a little slow to get up after that play there. And now Lowell will try and capitalize right side. Oh, nice job that battling was Luis Batista. Loses possession. Here's Weisenberger. Pass out wide. Nice ball into the center there. Trouble for Lopez. He had lost it at the first attempt. Lurking was Rupert, but luckily for Lopez, he was able to get back in time.
Yeah, Marcos Lopez, who had a sprawl out to his left to make the grab, didn't sure hand it the first time. It still bobbled around, and he made sure to reach out those hands a little bit further as attackers were coming on for Lowell.
Really trying to fire up the team here is Lopez, and it's been rather a lackadaisical start to the second half here for Mission. Lowell leading this game 1-0 from Boxer Stadium here in Balboa Park, San Francisco, the 2012 AAA Championship game. Again, Lowell clear, but Mission right there. Nice moves inside here. Mission still in possession on the far side. Send a ball into the box, but takes a deflection, I believe, off a Mission player. Well, off a Lowell player, excuse me, and it'll be a Mission corner kick from the far side. More substitutions coming up now for both teams. So let's see, the substitutions then coming off will be number nine. Marco Caballero will come back onto the field for the first time here in the second half. And he's scrambling to the far side of the field. He wants a quick corner here, and he gets it. A little bit too quick, I think, because the substitutions weren't yet made. Caballero trying to get away with one there. Now, short corner from Mission. Sent into the box. This could be trouble. Header goes up high and over the bar. Good chance in there. I believe that was Mario Mejia with the header there, but over the crossbar and a lower goal kick.
All right, folks, I'm going to give you the announcement really quick. Just want to let you know that PlayOnSports.com is not only your destination for Friday night football action, but it's also the place for the most comprehensive coverage of high school playoff and championship events in all sports from across the country like we are doing here today. Normally, football coverage is what you guys are accustomed to, but we have soccer championships live from Boxer Stadium in San Francisco. So remember, folks, playonsports.com. High school sports lives here.
Mission clearance here. Numbers now for Mission, but losing his footing. Number eight, Kevin Ochoa, looking downfield for Caballero. Ball out of bounds into touch. Mission really need a spark now to get back into this game. And will it come from the corner here? It should be a throw in, excuse me. Near to the corner flag. Fidel Cesares to take it. Long throw into the area. for that near post. Ball's loose right in front of goal. Cleared by Harrington. Scramble in front. And by Powers, Riggs was really caught off guard there.
You couldn't have asked for a better opportunity there for Mission. A good throw-in.
Frantic defensive
play. And that ball just bounced around in there. They had a chance to, it looked from here, they had a chance to just kind of just kick away at it. Just a little lift of the foot. But I guess they couldn't. They didn't have the right angle on it.
I think it was Ian James that played a clear there for Lowell. In the meantime, it's a Lowell free kick. That's going to fall in front of the goal, but cleared out by Mission as the referee's whistle goes. Yeah, that was Mission's best chance of the second half by far. An excellent throw-in.
We're going to take this time for another advertisement, folks, if you do not mind. Do you want to watch more of your school's great matchups like the game you are enjoying here today? Then tell your school to sign up for the Play On Sports School Broadcast Program. The program allows schools to broadcast all their games and other activities on the web. For more information, go to playonsports.com/SBP.
Tara's in possession left side, still battling with it. And he's still caught, and he's tripped up there. That's going to be a dangerous area for a free kick here. And a lot of credit should be given to Antonio Torres there for sticking with the ball, even with the attentions of two Lowell defenders. And this is now a very dangerous place for a free kick to be taken by Harrington. And this is a spot where you think Avery Fisher is the target man here.
He's got to be. Just flick that head on forward.
They've also got Moy and Weisenberger up there as well. James is now coming up from defense as well. So Lowell have the big boys up here in the box.
Weisenberger, who scored the first goal on a header.
Yeah, now a set piece. Very dangerous position here.
And Weisenberger's back right now.
Look for James on the edge of the 18-yard box here. The short free kick to him. He's unmarked. Here's the free kick in to the far post. Header was there. Ball's loose in front of goal, and Lopez is able to field it.
And great concentration and focus there by Marcos Lopez.
Absolutely.
There's a bunch of bodies in front of him, and for him to be able to find the ball and go after it and save it, really impressed with the goalkeeper there for Mission.
Here comes Mission to capitalize. Caballero, ball to the center, has a man in front. It's turned away by the Lowell defense. Funny how this game just, the tempo picks up so quickly. A chance for Lowell at one end and then quickly at the other end. Mission on the counterattack had a chance as well. Caballero making things happen there at the edge of the 18-yard box. It's a throw-in for Mission. Fidel Cazares will want to repeat the effort from last time. And, well, that's not his best throw-in by any stretch of the imagination.
Oh, that throw-in was absolutely horrible. I mean, it just...
Well, yeah, it's a shame because his previous one almost resulted in a Mission goal. Well, Cesares would really like to have that one back. Substitution then for both teams as Byron Rivera takes a seat. He's replaced by Brian Rodriguez.
And while there's some substitutions, one more add there, Steve. Sorry to cut you off. The Play On Sports is on Facebook and Twitter, folks. We are up to the social media, the hype and pretty much what's going to be the new trend, and that is us. We are there, Facebook, Twitter, giving you news, information, and links to great highlights. Follow us at Play On Sports on both Facebook and Twitter. You can like us on Facebook. You can also access thousands of live and on-demand games on YouTube. Remember to go to youtube.com/playonnetwork. Keep up with all the high school action every week from your destination for high school sports, playonsports.com.
Good effort there by Lowell, battling down the right side. His Mission have dropped an extra man back into defense now. It's opening things up in the midfield for the Cardinals.
But this is where Mission needs to go. Go, go, go.
Here's Caballero. Good ball in, flicked on, and it's fielded by Powers Riggs with an on-rushing forward there. He did well. Caballero now beginning to put his stamp on the midfield here in the second half. That comes off the shoulder of Harrington. Lost track of the ball. Mission have it. Steps around Harrington there. Nice effort there. They're trying to send the ball out the right side. Here's Byron Rodriguez in possession. Comes off a Lowell player. It'll be a Mission throw. More substitutions then as Mejia comes back in. He replaces Seviano. And Harrington will take a seat as Hernandez comes in for him. So a couple changes for both teams. Still a 1-0 lead for Lowell. Permission still looking to make something happen here. Ball into touch right side. Mission throw. Coach Kennedy wants his players to push forward now. Coming all the way out to the touchline here to bark out orders. Mission throw then for Rodriguez. Turning his Caballero. Steps around a player into the area. Good cross in. Has a player at the back post. The header is back to the center and over the crossbar. Oh, Mission now getting ever closer, but they've had a good couple of opportunities in front of goal and just have not been able to capitalize so far. Again, Caballero finding space, dancing between players. Had a man at the far post. This Lowell defense is really all of a sudden hanging on by a thread here, Michael.
Yeah, I think it was Mario Ruiz Reyes who had a head on it and just poked it up over the goalpost.
Caballero does well to find a player on the right side. Cross into the box. Has a player wide open. The header is saved. Tremendous save by Powers Riggs. Wow. What a save.
And that might be the play of the game
right
there.
Yeah, I would say so.
The loudest the crowd has gotten as Aiden Powers Riggs, a sophomore, shows his vertical and gets up for the block.
A fantastic save at full stretch to put the right hand up and tip the ball over the crossbar. Now the header is wide of the target.
And slamming his fist into the turf was the man who missed the header there.
It's Wanderlei D'Souza, the player there, was unmarked at the near post. But how about the substitute sophomore goalkeeper making the play of the day so far? How he got a hand on that, I'll never know. And the Lowell fans now are really fired up after that save. Chance of let's go Lowell come up from the fans below us.
Yeah, they're really getting that let's go Lowell chant going. They field it. That play, if they can just keep up, they can rally behind that. That might be the difference maker.
Things opening up now for both teams. Mission on attack to the right side. You get the feeling now the gloves are starting to come off and they're going to just let these two teams battle it out. Midway through the second half of play, Lowell lead 1-0. It's been a great game so far and the tempo has certainly picked up in the last couple minutes. Mission a little trouble clearing. Player goes down for Lowell. No foul given. Mission a second attempt to clear down the right side. That ball will go into touch. So it will be a Lowell throw. Got a couple players in support up ahead. I'll get a second attempt as the ball comes off. The Mission defender. Thrown to be taken by Alexander Rupert far side. So Lowell the lead, a 31st minute goal by Zachary Weisenberger, the difference in this one, but Mission knocking on the door in the last couple minutes. Lowell throw into the box is cleared by Mission. A couple players battling forward in midfield. Collision is going to go in the favor of Mission, so free kick coming up for the Bears. Trailing by a goal here, Michael.
Yeah, and the Bears really need to get things going here. Time's just continuing to tick away.
Aiden Powers Riggs with the play of the day so far. An absolutely spectacular save from a header, basically a point-blank range. Somehow able to get to it and turn it over the crossbar. Harrington here at possession on the near side. Good ball in the center. Now Lowell have some space here and players to work with. Sent to the outside. Good job there, corralled by Weisenberger. He's going to buy himself some time here and wait for support. It's a good ball there to slaughter back, and he gets pushed out of the way. No foul given.
And here we go. Numbers for Mission.
Yeah, they got a 3-on-3 here. Good ball threaded in. Nice defensive coverage there. Lowell clear. But you can see now, whereas early on in this game, the players really congregated around the middle of the field. There's a lot more space opening up now for both teams.
Folks, want to just remind you to stick around and stay tuned for the post-game show, where we will try to Well, we will select a player of the game, and then we'll try to get an interview with that player. We'll wrap up all the action from this 2012 City of San Francisco AAA Championship. That's coming up right here on the postgame show, playonsports.com, your destination for high school sports.
Torres again putting in work down that left wing, rewarded for his efforts with a throw in here for the Cardinals. Again, a dangerous spot now for Mission. They're trailing by a goal, don't forget. The defense will have to shore up here. Thrown to be taken by William Slaughterbeck. Good throw in there to the near post. Cleared out by Caballero. But Lowell's defense is right there. Pinball game in the midfield here today. Nice turn of pace there by Cortez. Searching ball downfield. Lowell defense there to clear. Sends that up into the student section. It'll be a Mission throw-in.
And that's one of the first long passes I've seen that have really looked good from Mission today. They really haven't tried to advance the ball further for their teammates. They've all been little passes from teammate to teammate. I'd like to see some long loft passes into the attacking zone.
Throw in taken by Mission to that near post, headed out calmly by Lowell, and an opportunity to clear now. Plenty of space here. No need to hurry, as many of the Mission players are already back down the other end of the field. And that's really a wasted opportunity there for Lowell.
Yeah, Lowell did rush things there. Should have just slowed it down a little bit.
They win the ball back in the midfield. A bit of too casual pass out. Oh, that's a great ball threaded through here. An opportunity for Luis Hernandez. But a couple players in support to his right. Picks out a player in the middle there. Oh, Harrington stepped over that. Why he let that one go, I'm not sure. Mission clear. And here's Caballero now. Wrong foots James brilliantly. Caballero, support to both sides. Pushes off a player. Has a shot from long range. It's wide of the target. Lowell defense not happy about that. As Caballero almost shoved James out of his way. Referee looks the other way, however. But Caballero haven't got away with the call there. Really wasted that opportunity. And it's a goal kick now for the Cardinals.
Yeah, Caballero just pushing and fighting to keep control of the ball. And then took a shot that went a little wide to the right.
So a substitution
and an
injured
player here.
Yeah.
I believe that's going to be...
It's Aaron Moy coming off.
Yeah, Aaron Moy coming off to the sideline.
Luis Batista to replace him. Quiet game from Moy so far. Goal kick's a short one. Luckily, Lowell somewhat there to clear, but falls in favor of Mission. And now Caballero dancing around, gets closed down. Three players all over him there. Caballero's decided it's time to put the game on his shoulders here for the Bears. Mission do well to retain possession. That surely went out of bounds. Despite the best efforts there of Brian Rodriguez to keep it in. Lowell throw coming up.
Sometimes it's hard to tell these players for Mission. They all have the same looking hairdo. Kind of that faux hawk, the yellow faux hawk for their team's colors.
About two-thirds of the way through this second period of play. Lowell lead this game 1-0. Harrington gets bundled over. Mission clear. Caballero now wrong foots James again. Create space in the middle of the field. Caballero still going. Has a couple players up ahead. Caballero, the long range shot is blocked and turned away. He'll maintain possession though. Caballero to the left side. Gets around a defender. Sends the ball in. Cleared again by Lowell. It's going to be a free kick to Lowell. Ball over the goal line, I assume. Zachary Weisenberger's 31st minute goal, the difference in this one. Now James again gets the shoulder charge. And they give the call in favor of Mission. Wow. Wow. Anyway, back to the action. Yeah,
that's kind of surprising that they gave the call to Mission there.
Ball sent downfield. Man in space, that was was Bautista, but his first touch was lacking. Mission maintained possession down the left side. Ball goes out of bounds. And a Lowell throw. So in the last quarter of this game now, just one goal of difference here. And for Lowell now, really just got to remain organized in the back like they've done so far. However, second goal, you think at this point, would almost certainly seal a deal here for the Cardinals. Good passing play here by Lowell, but Harrington unable to find his teammate, but doing a good job again down that left side is Hernandez, battling with defenders. Maintains possession for Lowell. Ball into the center, though, lacking. Hernandez right there. Caballero clears for Mission.
You can tell, mate, he has really gotten frustrated here in the second half.
Well, he's dropping back now into defense as well. He wants the ball. You can't blame him at this point.
Yeah, he really does want the ball, but, I mean, he's the one that missed on an opportunity earlier. He was the one slamming his fists into the turf after missing an opportunity on a throw-in.
Be a Lowell free kick.
He's really let Harrington get the best of him.
Harrington's ball into the box is headed out by Mission. Falls to James, however. James a little touch there, but again, Mission there to clear. Now, can Mission capitalize for the
Mejia.
First time?
He has the ball. Can he do something with it?
He did well on his first touch. Mejia steps around a play now, but Lowell's defense really has done a good job of closing players, making a run in there from the wing. Mejia, no choice there, but to send that over the goal line for a Lowell goal kick. And that's the thing, Lowell had done such a good job of closing down the middle. They give Caballero and Mejia no option but to go to the wing to try and send that one in. That's really been the difference in this game so far, as Lowell's defense, for the most part, has been very organized and has put a lot of pressure on this Mission Bears attack. So throw in here near side. Caballero, a little flick on there for Mejia. Good defense again by Lowell. That was Elijah Alperin there heading that one into touch. Or clearing, I should say, for a Lowell throw-in. That's going to be a throw in favor of Mission as it comes off a Lowell player. That was Bautista. Now Mejia ball comes off a Lowell defender and out of bounds. Coach Kennedy hustles over there to get the ball to the nearest player. And this is going to be taken by Cesarez. Now, can he get a decent throw in this time? Remember, his last one went over the goal line. Good throw again. It's got a lot of spin on it. Trouble for the Lowell defense. And he'll get a second time to send this one in. Lowell battling all the way here at the moment. Oh, and a missed kick opportunity. Powers Riggs sliding to retrieve the ball.
Like I said, watching that Muni light rail roll by, that's the mode of transportation in which the boys took to get here for Mission.
We saw them hopping off down the street there when just after we arrived.
The J line.
Plays battling far side. Go in favor of the Cardinals. Well inside the last quarter of this game now. Mission's defense stout all game. Just needs to shore it up for perhaps the last 10 minutes or so of this one. And Lowell will be three-time AAA champions.
Back to back to back.
They've got a little bit more work to do yet. And if Marco Caballero has anything to do with it, it'll make things very tricky for this Lowell defense in the last quarter of this game. Harrington far side, battling with the defender. Mission unable to clear, and Harrington comes up with it. Now, time for Harrington to send this one into the box. There's a couple players open, well defended by Mission that time. That could have been real trouble there for the Bear defense, but they're able to clear down this right side as Caballero challenging James there. Comes off the heel of James into touch for a mission throw. Caballero's good throw in. Back heel by Mejia. Cleared by Lowell.
Now Caballero calling for his teammates to get set up in a proper position here. As Mission knows, their chances are dwindling here.
They certainly
trying
are.
Trying to score a goal, and they want the best look they can get. And now it's a battle between the Let's Go Lowell and Let's Go Mission. I think you're starting to hear the Let's Go Lowell in a more resounding effort.
They're setting the table down on the sideline for the trophy presentation. Cesar's throw-in is a good one. It's headed over the goal line for a goal kick. And that's been the problem here today. Mission's chances have certainly been there, but...
Hey, you just got to give it up to Lowell for really reacting to, you know, what happened to them in the 4-2 loss earlier in the season.
Yeah.
And working on the things that they did wrong in that game. Coming out there and putting together a game plan that...
Now here's a chance. Mejia in space, right side. Oh, got his feet crossed up in front of him. The ball comes off his right foot into touch.
Putting together a game plan that would work against these Mission Bears. And even for Mission, man, you got to give props to Coach Kennedy's boys so far for only allowing this to be a 1-0 game for them to still be in it. You know, Coach Kennedy really has a lot to deal with as the head coach of Mission Soccer. As the school in a pretty rough area of town, and sometimes he can't quite get the talent he would like to get.
Time running out now for Mission. Ball cleared out by Lowell's defense, far side. Mission, you sense, maybe have a couple minutes left now. Waning moments of this game. It's still a 1-0 lead for Lowell. Zachary Weisenberger had it in the 31st minute, the difference so far. Mission trying to make something happen down that right, down the left side. Ball into touch. It's a Lowell throw. Lowell champions in 2011, 2012, and 2010, 2011.
5 minutes left in this contest, so there's still some time.
They defeated Lincoln 2-1 in 2011, coming back from one down in the second half. Aaron Moy a goal in the 30th minute. Jesus Sanchez a goal in the 51st. They then defeated Balboa 3-1 in 2010. Free kick for Mission now, and they're going to send everyone downfield. So 10 players inside the, or 9 players, excuse me, down inside the attacking half of the field for Mission. Turning is Caballero, is dispossessed, and now Lowell an opportunity to break. Harrington sends that one downfield. Mission's defense is there. Harrington will just avoid a sliding defender there. Ball into touch, Mission throw.
Heck, I'd even go hockey style and bring the goalie out for right now. Get as much man of an advantage
if they get another corner or free kick, we may well see that happen. Mejia battling down here on the near side. Ball into touch again. It's another Mission throw.
And look, that goalie way far out. He's just slowly creeping up.
Mission still battling here towards the end. Lowell want a foul, and they get it. As Weisenberger is fouled by Christian Cortez. Now for Lowell's defense, it's just stay solid, stay where they've been doing all game long. Being organized at the back, and it's paid dividends so far. Send the ball downfield. Mission's defense perhaps a little asleep at the wheel there as Luis Hernandez does well to hustle downfield and get a throw. But really, we've talked about Weisenberger's header, but the two saves by Powers Riggs may have preserved this lead more than anything else that Lowell had done today. Made a great save in the first half, and then, well, one of the saves of the year, to be sure,
yeah,
in the second half. Now, Mission, an opportunity here. They don't have numbers, but they... Lowell, again, have 5 players back. 2 players all over that forward there. A couple of final substitutions here for Mission. Ruiz Reyes is going to come on, as will Alvaro Veliz Quinonez. Mario Ruiz Reyes. So probably standing on some faster players here. As Mission, you feel, will have a couple more opportunities before the final whistle. Does well there. Mission, ball in the middle now. Chance in front. Shot is well off target. Well, Christine Cortez had a good look at that. But his shot lacking from 25 yards out. A goal kick for Lowell. Lowell fans getting ever closer now. But a poor clearance. 2 minutes now to go. Chance in front. Mejia's got a chance on goal. Wrong foot. Riggs shoots and scores. Mejia scores to tie it up at one.
And the guy who wanted it the most this entire game, begging for the ball, Mr. Mejia. Mario Mejia, Super Mario, I should call him, as he gets the goal and ignites his Mission crowd. And
Lowell
equalizes this game at one apiece.
Lowell defense in total shock. And you're right, Michael Mejia wanted the ball more than anybody else on this Mission team in the second half. A poor clearance by Lowell. Mejia was in all kinds of space. Sidestepped a player, fooled Powers Riggs. And his shot, a left-foot shot, into the top corner. 1-1 the score with less than 2 minutes to go. Now Lowell find themselves trying to get downfield and try and finish this one off. We'll have extra time, don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, should this game be tied at the end of regulation. James, far side, can't keep it in bounds. Mission now, they want to get downfield. They want to end this right here. Momentum has certainly swung back in their favor. But a poor pass.
Well, Coach Kennedy, he's very confident that his team is the better team. It's taken them nearly the entire game to show that. And right now they still haven't showed that as this game is tied up at one. No one's really been the better team today. But
unlucky for Lowell's defense because they were so solid through 78 minutes of this game. And then it all falls apart right at the end. But Mejia, though.
And now both fans once again trying to see who can yell out there, "Let's go, school name," louder. Started with a Mission one, and since Lowell has come in with their "Let's go, Lowell," and I think it's just overtaken the Mission fan base at this point.
Both sets of fans have been fairly quiet up until this point, but now both student sections chanting. We have an injured Lowell player on the far sideline. And this will add a little time. They'll go over to 10 to him. In the meantime, Lopez has come up. Ball downfield, cleared by Lowell, but Mejia's right there. Ball looking for Caballero. He shoulder charges the man out the way. Caballero on the right side. Turns inside of James. Into the box. Back to Caballero. Left foot shot. Ball into the box and just wide. Wow. Mission really had a chance there, but couldn't find a player open. It will be a corner kick, though, I believe.
Yeah, Caballero sent that one in.
Yeah.
Hoping that a defender could get any kind of body on it, or hoping that his teammate can get any kind of body on it, but wasn't meant to be. They will have a corner kick from the far top right, top right of your screen.
Caballero's to the near post. Four Mission players in the box. A couple of late substitutions here. What cruel luck this would be for Lowell if Mission could seal it here right at the end of the second half of play from a set piece. It's a corner kick from the far side. It's a good one into the box. Players in front. Oh, it's cleared off the line. It's still loose in front. Powers Riggs down to the ground, and he makes a fine save. Lowell won a foul on the goalkeeper. Boy, he made up for the goal by Mejia there because there was
Powers
a wild
Riggs.
Scramble in front of goal.
I thought that header was in, and Riggs went up and got it.
Definitely getting, you can imagine now with tensions rising out here on the field. The referee wants that free kick to be retaken. Just the one card issued so far in the game. To Ruiz Reyes. Mission now, another poor clearance by Lowell. have the ball. They're trying to pick out Mejia. It's cleared out of bounds by Elijah Alperin, and a throw in for Mission here. Waning moments of the second half. Feel this is going to be the last opportunity of the half before we go to extra time. It's going to be a long throw in from Cesarez. Spins towards that far post and handled by Powers Riggs.
Fidel Cesarez, his throw was...
And that's a full-time whistle. So we're going to go to extra time here in just a couple moments. But Mission sends in the pendulum swinging in their favor. A 78th-minute goal by Mario Mejia has tied this game up at 1. It's Lowell 1, Mission 1. We'll take a short break, and we'll be right back for the first period of extra time here on CIF SanFrancisco.tv, part of the Play On Sports Network, your home for high school sports.
We can get a player up here.
Oh, that's good stuff.
All right, perfect. Prepare a Wiley Ballard graphic.
Do you want me to start the stream?
Start the stream.
Camera 3.
Beautiful.
Oh, we're coming in on one.
For more information on how your school can join the Play On School broadcast program, go to playonsports.com/SBP.
Back with you live from Boxer Stadium here in Balboa Park, San Francisco. What an exciting end to that second half of play as Mario Mejia ties it up in the 78th minute.
Super Mario.
Super Mario indeed to level this game at 1-1. Let's go over the rules for the overtime periods here. The two teams will play two 10-minute halves without a golden goal. So regardless of whether or not a team scores.
Sorry about that, folks.
They have to play the full 20 minutes. If the score is tied after that 20 minutes are played, they will then go to the golden goal. 2 5-minute halves. Whoever scores first wins. If the two teams are tied after the 10-minute golden goal session of the game, we will have co-champions here in 2012.
So let me get this straight. They're going to play 2 10-minute halves?
Right. And that's... It's treated just like a regular game. So
like just like a mini game. Another mini game.
And then after that, it's 2 5-minute periods of golden goal play. So whoever scores first wins.
Okay. And if no one scores out of that, then will they go to PKs?
It's co-champions.
Okay.
So we just cleared that up with the announcing crew here at Boxer Stadium. So the two teams out on the field for the coin toss. The referee's explaining the rules to both captains. And the coin toss will determine who gets to kick off to begin the first period of extra time.
So will it be the men in the vertical stripes or the men in the horizontal stripes?
We'll have to wait and see.
The question.
I believe Lowell will get the opportunity to select which end they want to take first.
And a birthday amongst the Mission Bears soccer team is some of the Bears fans singing happy birthday to a player and his teammates squirting him with Gatorade.
Oh, to be a teenager again.
Sure.
So we are ready then to begin this first period of extra time to recap the scoring from the 80 minutes of regular time. Zach Weisenberger scored in the 31st minute with a header from 7 yards out. And then in the 78th minute, Mario Mejia scores with a powerful shot into the top right corner of the goal to tie this game up at 1. So we are ready now for the first extra time period. Mission will kick off. They'll go from right to left again in the Celtic-style hoop jerseys with the yellow and white stripes. Lowell in the red and white vertically striped shirts going from left to right.
Yellow's numbers outlined in brown with brown names on the back for the Mission Bears. Meanwhile, just plain black numbers on Lowell's jersey with no names.
You haven't said Mission wearing Nike yet. I'm surprised.
And yes, Mission are wearing the new Nike uniforms that Coach Kennedy feels they're playing better in. I know they look good.
First 10 minutes of extra time then. Mission in possession here left side. No doubt buoyed by the late goal by Mario Mejia. And an early opportunity now as they have possession down this left side with Christian Cortez battling in the corner there with Ian James. It'll be a goal kick for Lowell. How did the defense respond now, Michael, after that?
Well, I think both
let down there at the end of the second half because they were stellar up until that point.
Yeah, I think Lowell's defense just needs to get back to the basics. You know, there was a lot of times when they just let the Mission Bears get some long passes downfield, and that was something where Harrington, and Imperial Sales were doing such a good job of nixing that, and they really just need to follow with the Mission Bears. The Mission Bears were very sneaky towards the end there, making some moves and cuts and getting away from any kind of pressure defensively.
Well, Mission were able to open things up in the second half, and we saw a lot more space created in the midfield.
A lot more scoring opportunities.
And I think because Caballero was given a lot more reign to take command of the midfield. And the big problem Lowell had and have had in the beginning of this first period of extra time is just clearing the ball away, because they've been under constant barrage now for about the last 15 minutes or so of this game. And this time it was Harrington who's dropped way back now to help defend, who has to clear there and give Mission their first corner kick of this overtime period. Mission now have a big opportunity to take the lead for the first time today. 1-1 the score here in the first overtime period. About 2 minutes in, they'll play 2 10-minute halves. Here's the corner. It's a good one. Near post, headed on, cleared by Lowell. Mejia is right there to help mop up. Now he could send that one back into the penalty area. Again, cleared by Lowell. Back to the Mission half of the field. That takes a bounce off a Lowell player. Now all of a sudden they have a counterattack and a 3-on-3 here. Just a little bit too much there for Lowell as Lopez mops up. Another good boot downfield. Gives trouble for James. 4 Mission players in the area. And Caballero has it. Does well. Picks out a player. Caballero in possession now. Players in support to each side. Good cross in there from Caballero. Looking for his counterpart up front, but headed wide. A goal kick for Lowell.
And that was Seviano charging up and trying to get ahead on it.
Rather quiet in the second half after what could be arguably Mission's best opportunity of that first half with a shot from 6 or 7 yards out, went into the side netting. 1-1 the score then here in the overtime period. It'll be a throw into Lowell on the far side. And after a bright start to the first half on attack for the Cardinals, they've really struggled to really make any chances here in the second half.
I was going to say, Marcos Lopez has had a very quiet second half.
Yes.
Hasn't had to make a lot of saves.
He has indeed. And it goes back to what Coach Estevez was saying. They have had trouble scoring. Remember, their only goal of this game came from a set piece. Now, Lowell on the attack. Mission defense is right there.
And that ball barely sneaked in, as I was alluding to earlier. I mean, that was a header that just barely, narrowly got in to the goalpost.
Mission here, or Lowell, excuse me, ready to make a couple of substitutions. Wasn't the greatest clearance in the world by Mission. Lowell unable to capitalize. Slaughterback battling with a player here near his side. Mejia stepped over the ball, lost his footing, and that's going to be offside against Lowell. And really then, when they have an opportunity, forwards offside. That was Freddie Marin in the game for the first time this afternoon. Offside. And he was about 3 feet offside there at least. So free kick for Mission. Reaching the midpoint of this first period of overtime. These two teams locked up at one apiece. Free kick finds Mejia in plenty of space here. Header inside for Caballero. It's cleared. Now we'll go out of bounds for a Lowell throw. So 2 10-minute extra time periods in this game. They'll go then to 2 5-minute golden goal periods. The first team to score will win the game outright. Should the two teams be tied after the 10-minute golden goal period, we will have co-champions in 2012 here in the San Francisco section. Throwing for Lowell and far side. Lowell now have to battle. Here's Freddie Marin. Marin trying to wrong-footed defender. Has to go one way and then another. Loses his footing. Good defensive effort there by Mission. They'll send the ball downfield. Harrington is right there. Harrington steps over a player. But he's dispossessed. And now here come Mission. 4-on-3.
Numbers for Mission.
Good ball to the outside. Nice turn in there. Ball floated into the box. Takes deflection off a Lowell player. Oh, left foot shot is just wide. That was on a hop there, and the shot by Fidel Cesarez is just wide. And they want a corner kick, and I think we're going to get it here.
I just wish that Bears attacker would have turned in a little earlier to make that pass. but he did have defense draped all over him. I believe that was Ruiz Reyes.
Mejia to take the corner kick. Floats in the center of the area. Headed away by Lowell. The mission were right there. Nice turn on the outside. Good ball in. Trouble here potentially. To the far side turn and just missing the shot. Cleared by Lowell. Powers Riggs having to defend both sides of the goal here. Headed in once again. Mejia was there. Low shot. Bounces off the chest of Powers Riggs and he's able to field it. Good second effort
there. That was Sandoval who took a big whiff and miss on that goal attempt. Ever Alex Sandoval missing.
Marin still battling that far side. Lowell attempting to clear. That came off the hand of the mission play. Yeah, handball. Lowell free kick. These Golemar scrambles again a little frantic now for the Lowell defense. You're right. A big whiff there as he tried to really had his back to the goal, trying to turn and shoot at the same time.
And he had to take a high kick, too. He had to really raise his leg up. And now it's
Caballero,
a
good ball. He's offside, surely, and he is. Yeah, he was offside. A great through ball by Caballero, but the timing was just off. Forward pleading his case. Can't believe it, but the flag went up straight away.
Now, there was that slight hesitation before he passed it off. If it was just a one-time pass, who knows? I think that would have been considered still onside at the moment.
I think Wanderlei D'Souza would have been offside regardless of the timing, but all the same, a good-looking through ball though from Caballero. And that's really the first one that's worked today. Now, back the other way come Lowell. That's snuffed out by the mission defense. Long-range shot won't really trouble Lopez that much.
That one almost made it through the goalpost.
Yeah.
Behind the goalpost, the football goalpost, which are set up behind the soccer goalpost.
Goal kick then for Lopez.
Still a very sunshiny day here in the city by the bay. Just gorgeous weather.
Lowell desperately need a spark.
And a slide tackle there. And that might get a yellow card drawn out as the ref is walking over to him. He says he's down on the ground. He says, hey, bud, you're going to have to get up because I'm going to show you a little something. I think this is where he's going to present him with the yellow card.
Well, sliding tackle, and the mission defender came off the worst of it. Usually it's the other way around on those hard slide tackles like that, but I think he will get his name in the book. The second yellow card of the day then for mission. Yeah, and he comes up hobbled. We'll see who that is now, and he makes his way over to the touchline. In the meantime, Byron Rivera will come on. So free kick then for Lowell. Harrington will take it. He's got Jameson support to his right. Five players in the box for Lowell.
Harrington, who had a very steady first half, had some good touches on the ball. Really advanced the ball far down the field.
But that's been one of the problems, though, for Lowell, is Harrington started out playing forward in this game and has had to retreat further back to help shore up this Lowell defense. His free kick is a good one, troubling for Lopez over the crossbar.
Nearly floated that one in.
Yeah. It was Alex Sandoval, the player that got the yellow card. End of the first period of extra time. Team's still tied up at one, so the teams will switch ends in for the second period of extra time. And following this 10-minute period, we will go to the first of two 5-minute golden goal periods. The first team to score during that time will win the game.
Now this period, this second half, they will play all the way out, even if a goal is scored?
That's correct. So Coach Kennedy calls the Bears over for a quick word. As does Coach Estevez as well.
And folks, just want to remind you one more time. Sorry, Stephen. One more time to stick around and stay tuned for the PlayOnSports.com post-game show, where upon the conclusion of this exciting and exhilarating sectional final in the AAA section for the city of San Francisco between the Lowell Cardinals and the Mission Bears, We will break down the game. We will pick out a player of the game, and then we'll try to have an interview with that player of the game. That's coming up on the post-game show here following the conclusion of this game on playonsports.com. High school sports lives here.
Thank you, sir. Second period of extra time about to get underway. Lowell going from right to left now will kick off the second period. Score still tied up at one here. Final substitution here just before the beginning of the second period as Sandoval comes back in to replace Rivera. So Sandoval and Ruiz Reyes, both with yellow cards for Mission. The only two issued today so far. One has been a physical, if fairly well-tempered manner, I'd say. Considering the...
Yeah, we've only seen, what was that, the second yellow card all day?
Yeah. And none for Lowell
just before the end of the first
so far.
Half.
Now a little bit of trouble here for Mission to corral the ball, and Lowell able to come up with it. Slaughter back, good pass to the outside. Now they create some space here. But poor first touch, and here comes Mejia down the right side. Has support in the middle. Mejia. Oh, turns the play well. Shoots. Oh, turned away nicely by James. A foul down the left side. That could be the first yellow of the day for Lowell.
Yep, and that referee definitely has it out.
Yeah, that's going to be Luis Bautista.
He's going to walk over to Bautista and show him the card. Yep, he is. And the Lowell fans do not agree with the call, but I think it was the right one as he came charging and clearly slid. I mean, he could have avoided that, but he clearly went into Mejia. And so now he'll have a seat.
Referee, for the most part, has been pretty good about letting the play go here today, but felt he had no choice there but to book Bautista, and he reached into his pocket right away. Now more worrisome here for Lowell is Mission have a dangerous free kick now from about 25 yards out here on the near side. Five players congregated to that far post. Powers Riggs ready on his line. Two players in the wall here for Mission. It's a quick free kick looking for May here, but too much mustard on it. And that rolls into touch. And that's certainly a wasted opportunity for Mission after the booking of Bautista. Goal kick for Lowell.
And once again, the Lowell fans letting their voices be heard.
Samuel Ryan comes out. Luis Bautista back in the game. He'll go over to the left side of the midfield, or the right side of the midfield, excuse me. And another poor goal kick, and now here come Mission to capitalize. It's Caballero to the right wing. Caballero trying to turn inside a defender, cleared out by Lowell, throw in for Mission. Cesarez will take it. He's given this Lowell defense fits all day with these long throw-ins. We'll need a good one here. Take an extra step back here to throw in. Here's a throw-in. A lot of spin on it. Dangerous into the middle of the box. Shot turned on. Cleared by Lowell. Scramble again. Mejia was right there for Mission. Takes a bounce off a Lowell defender. Lowell will concede a corner kick here, and this is going to be taken quickly by, I was going to say, I thought it was going to be taken quickly by Mission, but there's an injured player down for Lowell inside the penalty area.
That's the third injured player we've seen for Lowell today.
Something happened off the ball there, and they're going to call for the coaching staff to come take a look at the player. They have a substitution here. James will take a seat, I believe. Let's see. The injured player, I believe, was Weisenberger. Might have got an elbow or something in the...
The man who's responsible for the lone goal on the board for...
Yeah.
The Lowell Cardinals, and you hate to lose a guy such as him who can provide an offensive spark. James Baldwin
coming in. Weisenberg and James and Harrington have played pretty much this entire game. And they've really had to dig deep here for the the second stage of extra time. And you can imagine both teams now starting to feel just a little tired as Jeremy left Fortune coming on to replace Weisenberger. Corner kick then for Mission to the near side.
And Weisenberger
headers there and wide of the target.
Weisenberger wants back on the field immediately. He says he's fine. Coach Estevez making sure that he's fine.
Senior captain wants back on the field as soon as possible. Left Fortune's appearance in the game was short.
One of four seniors, and Weisenberger is back on the field. Him along with Harrington, Jeremy LaFortune, who's, I'm sure the fans are really clapping up to see senior get on the field for a brief moment.
Now Lowell, bright in the counterattack, but cleared away by Mission. It's a nice effort over there by Avery Fisher, making a run down the right side. But cleared out by the Mission defense, and a throw in for Lowell. About midway through the second period now of extra time. The golden goal period of play to follow. 2 5-minute halves. Nice play on the outside. Good cross into the back post. No one home for Lowell. Cleared by Mission. Mayhee is right there. And he'll turn inside of Harrington. Oh, Harrington does well to dispossess Mayhee. And a good ball ahead. And he was looking up front for Bautista there. Just couldn't get the pass off in time. The free kick goes in favor of Mission, however.
Yeah, after the handball violation there.
So free kick for Mission. And they're going to send everyone down once again. Just Lopez and the free kick taker inside the Mission half of the field. It's not the greatest free kick.
Yeah,
and
right,
Lowell clear.
Weisenberger.
Marin does his best to try and keep that in bounds. Now we've got to play it down for Mission. And that's cramp, I think. That's going to be William Salvador to play it down for Mission. Yeah. I mean, we approach the waning stages of this game. Fatigue setting in. Just a couple of minutes to go now in the second overtime period, and then we'll begin the golden goal period of this game. Salvador is back up on his feet. He'll take a moment or two here, and he's replaced by Byron Rivera. So Mission throw inside the Lowell half of the field. Game still tied up at one. Weisenberger and Mayhee are the scorers for Lowell and Mission respectively. Short throw in. Headed clear by Lowell, and be another throw in for Mission. Overstrides Cesares to take it. Mission with every play except for Lopez in the attacking half of the field. This is right in Cesares' range. He will put some spin on the ball here from the throw-in to the near post. Headed back to the back post, no one home, cleared by Lowell. Finally able to get it out right side. Cleared by Lowell, and a throw in for Mission.
All right, so we'll see how Mission sets up here, Steve. This is another chance to possibly end the game.
Another long throw in, this time from the far side. Mission have a player lurking at the back post there. No one home in the center, though. Mission come up with it. Right side, good ball through there. Caballero up against the goal line. Left foot cross, takes a deflection. Loose in front of goal. That's a dangerous place to have the ball there for Lowell, and they're able to clear.
It's still in the zone, though, however. They can't completely clear it out.
Mission with every player forward, as we mentioned. Caballero still open on that right side. Working against Slaughterback, turns inside him. Caballero still with possession, still got it, shoots and turned away again by Powers Riggs. Another fine save by the sophomore.
Wow, Aiden Powers Riggs. Way to step up and make another spectacular save, sprawling out this time to his right. And that's like a save you see professional goalies in the World Cup make
absolutely.
Right
Brilliant play by Powers Riggs, but more importantly there, Caballero finally able to dance between players and create a shot coming off the right wing. Corner kick mission. All the players grouped to that far post. Floats it in. A lot of traffic in the area. Header is wide. Lowell will clear. Harrington sends it downfield. Mejia gives chase. Caballero can't keep it in. Just a little bit out of his reach. And it's a throw in now for Lowell. It'll be a second consecutive one as it bounces off a mission defender. Really can't be more than a minute and a half to go now in the second overtime period. Harrington to throw in. Sends it downfield. Weisenberger was free of a defender. He's still got possession to the center of the field. Weisenberger to Marin. Cleared by Mission's defense. Whistle goes. And that's going to end the second overtime period. So we now go to the golden goal. 2 5-minute periods. The first team to score will win the game. Should both teams be tied after the 2 5-minute periods, we will go to overtime. Or, we will go to co-champions for the 2012 AAA championship game. Just taking a quick break here. Michael Smith will give us some advertisements as the two teams will take a quick break before we start this golden goal period of the game. 1-1 the score here from Boxer Stadium in Balboa Park, San Francisco. Lowell and Mission all tied up at 1 after 100 minutes of action.
All right. Thank you, Stephen. Folks, follow us on Facebook and Twitter. That's right. We have caught up to the social media as we give you news, information, and links to great highlights. You can like us on Facebook. You can definitely follow us on Twitter. And you can also access thousands of live and on-demand games on YouTube. That's at youtube.com/playonnetwork. Keep up with all the high school action every week from your destination for high school sports, playonsports.com.
A quick programming note, we will be covering the Turkey Day Bowl from the city of San Francisco, Kezar Stadium on the 22nd.
I think that's you and I.
Yeah, I think
that
it
one,
is.
Steve.
So that's
I can't wait.
That's going to be the super exciting game.
The venerable Kezar Stadium.
Yeah.
Stadium in which was, if you go to maxpreps.com, it was one of the top 10 high school football stadiums that you should check out. I don't know if you've had a time to take a look at that slideshow, Steve, but, man, there are some really breathtaking high school football stadiums.
The one they built in Texas, $60 million.
That yeah, where Allen plays, too. That one's awesome. Or even Washington High School in San Francisco, their field gives you a view of the Golden Gate Bridge. I mean, you can't beat that.
No, you can't. And one other quick programming note, if we may. This Thursday, we'll be presenting the girls' volleyball championship game in the San Francisco section as well. So high school sports fans here in the great city of San Francisco have a lot to look forward to, if I may say so.
That's right. I want to say I'm going to be there on that one as well, but I'm not too sure.
This Thursday, 7 o'clock, I believe.
Yeah. So. Actually, I think I have a game Friday night.
And for Play On Sports in particular, we will be going all out over the next month. So we have championships in every sport. We're doing tennis, golf, cross country, soccer, football, you name it. We'll be there in the San Francisco section and beyond. So it's a great time of year for high school sports fans all over the state of California. Golden goal period number one about to begin then.
It's hard to believe, though, that the last week of the regular season was this past week for football.
I know.
I mean, you know, especially now with the game starting a week earlier this year, the whole season starting a week earlier to allow time to have that intermediate game between the section championships and the state bowl games, the kind of play-in playoff game, if you will, to get into the state bowl game, which adds a little spice, a little intrigue.
So two teams getting ready then to come back out, given about 5 minutes or so between the extra time and now the golden goal extra time as well. think co-champion is certainly a better way to go than sorting out the victor of this game via penalty kicks. Because we all know it's the worst way to lose a professional game.
Right. Sure. I mean, at least with co-champions, you know that, hey, look, we both fought hard and we left it all on the field and we're just two great teams, probably equally great, and boom. You know, where if you get into the penalty kick situation, then, you know, it was left for chance, and you'll always have the losing team wondering, what if? I mean, what if we would have had our chance, you know? I guess the penalty kick does ultimately give you your chance, but still, I like a co-champion situation.
Yeah, I think
our producer, Zach Farmer, not in agreement with us on that. And maybe because he knows these schools a little bit more. I mean,
that's true.
He's telling us, I mean, both of these schools, especially Mission, you know, they're just so happy that their whole athletic program has taken a big boost. I mean, they were a school that wasn't quite good in anything. Like I said, they're kind of I'm not going to say bad area, but a very tough area to be successful in athletics, just with all the other things surrounding them in that environment. So for them to be in the championship, you know, a place where they're very familiar with in the past, not so of the recent of late for the last 3 years, but they are happy to be here in Lowell, a team that's always in the mix.
So the captains will meet once again for another coin toss to determine which side of the field they'll take.
So now first goal would win here, though,
right? First goal wins, that's it.
No matter what.
The only other fair, perhaps an only for title game, would be to do a replay, but then you may have the same problem again where you go through 110 minutes of action and you still don't have a winner. Both teams battle hard in a game full of momentum changes, some absolutely sensational goalkeeping play, and a couple of moments of magic for both teams aboard us to this 1-1 scoreline we have currently as we start this first golden goal period.
We'll see if Fisher makes any moves here in this sudden death period. You know, he kind of stayed back because he has to defensively, but we'll see if he maybe takes a couple of risks and sees, and we'll find out if a reward can pay off for him.
Well, the other play that you'd like to see, at least for Lowell, make some noise here in this overtime period is Aaron Moyes. Had a quiet game, to say the least. So here's Weisenberg already working hard, and he just can't keep that inbounds down the right side. Caballero giving chase. Mission working quickly to get the ball back inbounds. Lowell have it. Center of the field. Here's Marin. Can't shake off a player. Nice moves there by Mission player, but a little bit too hard. Loose possession. Some tired legs out there, as you can imagine. Cleared out far side by Avery Fisher. Still maintaining possession. Now sends the ball downfield. Looking for Alperin.
We just really couldn't have asked for a better championship so far, Steve, with both teams right now into a double overtime period. Tied at one.
Scrappy player over on the far side, but Lowell come off the best. Bring the ball down the right or down the left side. Missed opportunities there from Mission defense. They clear. Lowell wanted to hand ball there. Actually, both teams could have had one. But Lowell maintained possession. There's a ball out to the right side. Now, Lowell send it in. Cross looking for Weisenberger. No one home. Mission can't clear that far out. And it's Lowell now in the second, or in this first golden goal period. They're sending players forward. Just three players back that time. Mission throw now into the attacking third of play. And they'll send practically everyone forward. Good long throw in again. To the back post, player open in front of goal, turned away by Lowell. Second effort, they're headed in. Powers Riggs has it. The flag went for offside. So still tied up at one here. Both sets of fans on their feet. Remember, the first goal will win it. Lowell out to the far side. It's Bautista. He had a quiet second half. in possession down the left side to the center of the field. Cleared by Mission. Trying to turn there was Mejia, and he comes away with it. Mejia now in possession, Mejia to his left. Caballero still with it, shoots, and Powers Riggs is right there to make the save and cleared. Stinging in the hands of Powers Riggs, couldn't corral it. Cleared by Lowell's defense, and it's going to be a corner kick.
Yeah, Powers Riggs with the initial stop, and then the ball is still bounced around, and luckily Bautista came to the rescue and cleared it out.
It's Mejia to take the corner from the near side. Eight players forward here for Mission. To the back post, punched away by Powers Riggs. A little bit of mix-up in communication, though, on the clearance, and Mission have it. Long ball sent in to the center of the box. Far side, chance on goal. Shot turned away and over the crossbar and out of play. Corner kick given to Mission. Powers Riggs did well there to emerge from the crowd and punch the ball away, but Lowell's clearances haven't been the greatest in the latter stages of this game. They almost let Mission in again. Mission get a corner kick out of it. Powers Riggs defending that back post. Short corner. Near side, turned away off the goal line by Lowell. Wow, Powers Riggs was beaten there. Frantic moments here. Cleared by Lowell, finally. Mejia dispossessed. Wins it back. Oh, I was about to say turn between two players. Out of bounds. Throw to Mission. They want to work quick here as Lowell trying to plead their case for the throw with the referee. Back to Mejia. It's player in support to his left. Turns inside.
Oh, poor decision there,
yeah,
by Mejia.
Yeah, throws that away.
I mean, he did a good job of dancing around with the ball and getting himself an open look, but he was kind of, from my angle, he was too far, and he had some wide open teammates to pass to that would have had better looks.
Couldn't make his mind if he wanted to pass or shoot on goal. And throws away a good Mission opportunity there. Goal kick downfield. Mission have it. Ball play battling in the middle of the field. There's Mejia once, or Caballero to Mejia downfield. And that's going to be the first period of golden goal overtime concluded. They'll switch ends for the second. Just 5 minutes and perhaps a little injury time remaining in this one.
Looking here at the record books to see if there's ever been co-champions.
Yeah,
there has been.
Been a few. Mission, I think, had a part in all of them, if I remember correctly.
And yes, they have. There's been three co-champions. Last one coming in 1964-65. That was Mission and Washington, my dad's old alma mater. And then Galileo and Mission were co-champs in 55-56. And in 46-47, it was also Galileo and Mission as co-champs. So it's been a long time since the San Francisco City section has seen co-champs, but if no goal is scored here in 5 minutes, they will see it.
Both sets of fans on their feet applauding the two teams. We get the second half of goal. Here's a chance for Harrington. Turns inside, there's a player open, and oh, he got rid of it. What was he thinking? Has Slaughterback, Weisenberger making a run into the center. Oh, Harrington going for glory there. Sends a shot over the crossbar.
Harrington just had too much momentum as he went into
yeah.
that kick and put way too much touch on it than he wanted to.
Caballero does well to claim the ball in midfield. Caballero still with good legs going. Good pass outside to Mejia. Mejia dancing around. Oh, nice moves. He gets the push.
Wow,
no card.
Made.
No whistle either.
As Mejia is down on the ground. Just gets shoved.
Mejia should be paying attention. The ball fell to him and he just lets it go. It's going to be a corner kick, but Lowell defense is nowhere near him there.
And Coach Kennedy advising his teammates to get all of them get close to the goal, get close to inside the box.
Corner kick then for Mission. Floats it into the near post. Trouble here. Headed away by Lowell's defense. Forced to Mejia. Nice moves. Mejia's still turning. dancing around inside the penalty area, and would have been spectacular, but Lowell clear. Both teams with chances here in this extra or second golden goal extra time period. Throw to Lowell. Ball came off Caballero as he was battling there with Ryan Lindsay. A lot of hands on hips here as we reach the final couple minutes of this game. Officials conferring here. They want to make sure that the time is being kept. Just battling for it here in the midfield. Cesarez is battling the Lowell player midfield. Comes off his boot. Still bouncing around. Lowell trying their best to clear. That's going to be a throw into mission. Cesarez to take it. Spins it into Mejia. Bounces off Caballero. It's loose in front. Sent back. Right idea, though, to try and set up a second shot. Back into the middle, turning and firing, shoots. Turned away.
Oh,
cleared by Lowell. Go long-range shot, and that's wide of the target. Boy, Mission have had their chances here, Michael.
Yeah, they sure did, and they took a couple shots.
It was the right idea to square it back instead of trying to turn and shoot from an impossible angle, but the Lowell defense able to close them down.
Yeah, in front of every shot, blocking every shot, especially the man who was down on the ground, just happened to be down on the ground at the right time.
Well, the best chance Mission have had in this entire golden goal period was the shot that was headed off the line with Powers Riggs well beaten just a few minutes ago, but Mission still keeping the pressure on this Lowell defense. They try to scramble the ball clear and unable to do so. Bring it into the box, cleared by Lowell's defense. Downfield. But Lowell just don't have the numbers up front. And they can't capitalize on these clearance opportunities. They've kept more or less everybody back now. Good ball. Mejia wanted it, but Lowell able to clear down the left side. Mission keep it inside. Long ball downfield. Now 2-on-2 here. Good clearance required, and look how close Lopez was to the edge of the penalty area to claim that one.
45 seconds left, Steve. Someone's got to get a goal quickly here.
Well, it's going to come down to the last second. Maybe one more option for Mission here. Low in possession, far side. 2-on-2 here. Things really opening him up at the back now. This is Lowell's best chance here. Ball into the center. It's not the best clearance. Falls for Lowell. Weisenberger tackled nicely. One more chance here. They're going to have to just fire on goal. Flag is up on the far side. Offside for Lowell. Cesarez clears downfield. Lowell in possession here. Surely the last attacking chance of the game now for either team. And there it goes. The final whistle. And we have co-champions for the first time in the San Francisco section since 1964-1965. What a game between these two teams as Lowell and Mission, after 110 minutes of play, are tied at a goal apiece. Both teams receiving a hearty round of applause from both sets of fans.
Now, how are they going to do this? They're going to saw the trophy in half?
They both have to lift one hand each, I would imagine. But
oh, boy.
Well, you know both teams are disappointed.
Yeah, well, you know what? They both fought really hard out there, and that's one thing you got to give the boys credit. They're just two good teams going at it, and you're going to expect the game to be close. I didn't expect it to be this close, especially from a Mission team who's averaged almost 5 goals a game this year. And Lowell was up for the task, and Mission surely shored up their defense in the second half. And this just was an overall very exciting game to broadcast.
Players of the game. Mine's going to be Powers Riggs. Absolutely outstanding goalkeeper play, yeah.
Yeah, you know, I almost feel like we should get two players in the game here.
It's only fair, I think.
You know, and if you're going to go with Powers Riggs, I got to go with Super Mario there.
Yeah.
I was Mario for Halloween. He's the one that gets the lone goal and makes this a tie game with very short time remaining. So I'll go try to get Powers Riggs and Super Mario, and we'll do this player to game interview, folks. So stick around for the post-game show. Don't go anywhere. That's coming up in just a few moments here on playonsports.com.
We can get a player up here.
Oh, that's good stuff.
All right, perfect. Prepare a Wiley Ballard graphic.
Do you want me to start the stream?
Start the stream. Camera three. Beautiful. Oh, we're coming in on one.
For more information on how your school can join the Play On School broadcast program, go to playonsports.com/SBP.
Will be awarded to mission, the same medals, mission players, and then it will be the turn for mission to receive the trophy and to take a picture with the medals and the trophy. So again, first we call the lower players. They will be granted the medals and given the opportunity to take a picture with the medals and the trophy. And then we will call the mission players and do the same thing. So we are going to roll, congratulated by our lower players, please line up. We are going to call names. You are going to receive congratulations from Mr. Collins, the Commissioner of Athletics, and Mr. Bob Camino, the head of soccer. So here we go, for handshakes with Mr. Collins, Victor Nogueira, number two, Victor Nogueira, Lowell. So the next one will be Daniel Sander. Daniel Sander, Lowell, player number 15. Daniel Sander, Lowell, player number 15. Sam Miller, Lowell, player number 21. Sam Miller, you're going to get a handshake from Mr. Collins. Daniel Sulon, number 23, a handshake from Mr. Collins. And the last handshake, Noah Boden Kologorski, number 33. Now for the medals, Abdul Monim, number 1. Aiden Power Riggs. Cookie Imperial Sales, number 5. Samuel Ryan, number 6. Antonio Torres, number 7. Luis Hernandez, number 8. William Slaughterback, number 9. Zach Weisenberger, number 10. Peter Harrington, number 11. Ian James, number 12. Elijah Alperin, number 13. Jeremy LaFortune, number 14. Arbel Efrati, number 16. Ryan Lindsay, number 17. Avery Fisher, number 18. Aaron Moy, number 19. Lincoln Chapman, number 20. Alex Rupert, number 22. Luis Bautista, number 25. Tim Ayers, number 27. Sam Scharfenberger, number 31. And Freddie Marine, number 34. That's it. That's the last one. And the trophy now is going to be held by Mr. Marcos Estevez, head coach for Lowell High School. So the official picture, co-champs for the year 2012-2013, Lowell Cardinals. Now is the presentation for the mission players and the mission coaching staff. Here again, Mr. Collins, Mr. Gamino will present first place medal to Mission High School players. The first set of players are going to call will receive a handshake from Mr. Collins. Jesus Cáceres, number one. William Tekle Georges, number six. Kevin Ochoa, number eight. Hakim Mansori, number 14. Jimmy Diana, number 20. Marvin Ortiz, number 24. Justice Molina, number 25. Samuel Villarreal, number 26. Salem Bu Hassoun, number 30. James Baldwin, number 31. And Hawkins Stern, number 32. Now, for the medals, Marcos Lopez, goalkeeper, and number one. Ulises Martinez, number two. William Salvador, number three. Brian Rodriguez, number four. Victor Sanchez, number five. Ronnie Bautista, number six. Christian Cortez, number seven. Walter Sevillano, number eight. Marco Caballero, number nine. Irving Herrera, number 10. Mario Ruiz Reyes, number 11. Miles Pittman, number 12. Byron Rivera, number 13. Jonathan Ochoa, 15. Alvaro Belis Quiñones, number 16. Fidel Cáceres, number 17. Alder Soto Coronel, 18. Byron Paz Portillo, 19. Tan Gok Lee, 20. Dominic May, 21. Mario Mejia, 23. Ever Alex Sandoval, 26. Quentin Ikehara, 27. And Hugo Wanderley de Souza, number 29. And the trophy from the hands of Mr. Collins, the Commissioner of Athletics, to Mr. Kennedy's hands, head coach of Mission High School. Kennedy, the assistant coach, Wilson Jimenez, and on the Lowell side, along with Marcos Estevez as the head coach, was Mr. Jim Hayashi and Jim Rana as assistant coaches. once again, a big hand to all the players and the officials that made this a beautiful afternoon. A beautiful soccer afternoon. Both teams with the official picture.
We can get a player up here.
Oh, that's good stuff.
All right, perfect. Prepare a Wiley Ballard graphic.
Do you want me to start the stream?
Start the stream. Camera three. Beautiful. Oh, we're coming in on one.
For more information on how your school can join the Play On School broadcast program, go to playonsports.com/SBP.
All right, folks, welcome back to our post-game show here. Final score for the 2012 San Francisco City Section Championships for boys soccer is a tie game, 1-1. Co-champions were with one half of the co-champion representing squad, the Lowell Cardinals sophomore goalie, Aiden Powers-Riggs. Aiden, phenomenal game today. You had a bunch of just saves that you see out of professional goalies in the World Cup and everything. And
thank you.
I guess you wouldn't have got your chance if it wasn't for Abdul Moneen going out with an injury. When you saw the injury go down, I mean, it was a scoreless game. What were your initial thoughts? I mean, were you nervous to come in? Or were you excited to come in?
You know, I was really nervous, but I knew what I had to do, and my teammates really lifted me up, and they really I had a little trouble in the beginning of the season, but you know, they really gave me a lot of confidence, and they said I could do it, and so I did.
And was this the first action you'd seen all year, or have you?
In the beginning of the year, the Abdul got hurt. He got a concussion, so I was in for a couple games, and I didn't really do so well. So now it's just a big change.
Timing-wise, I mean, what allowed you to time out some of those? I mean, seriously, I mean, you were just punching them out, making sprawling out saves. I mean, what do you credit that to? I mean, were they just the shots kind of coming easy, or just, you know, were you ready for them? And just,
you know, I don't know. They were great shots. Me and Abdul, we worked a lot together the whole season, and you know, he's just a great teammate, and we just worked great together and really prepared me for this.
Obviously, I mean, co-champions, you're happy, but then you're not happy. I'm sure you wish it could ultimately be decided for a championship, but not too bad. You guys still kind of carry the back-to-back-to-back theme, and this year as a sophomore, you still have plenty of years to go through the ranks and continue to rise, and this is going to be your program from here on out. So I just want to congratulate you once again on your championship. Do you have any final words that you want to say to the people out there?
Not really.
No? Uh-huh. Okay, folks, that's Aiden Powers-Riggs out of Lowell High School, one of our co-players of the game. And then so hold up that trophy,
okay,
at least, before you take off. There we go. And now we'll get Marco Caballero. He's going to come over and join us. And then maybe just stick around in the background, and right before we leave, we'll have a final shot of you guys both holding the trophy. But for right now, we'll have Marco involved in the mix. So if you can, just stand back a little bit, Powers-Riggs, and then we'll get you in the mix. So, Marco, you boys fought hard tonight, or this afternoon, I should say. A 1-1 game. You guys were down 1-0, and you made the comeback. What was the halftime kind of chat from Coach all about? I mean, I'm sure he wasn't too happy with you guys trailing 1-0 at half.
Well, he just told us to keep our head up and not to give up, because everything came down to the second half, to 40 minutes, and we took his word. So, you know, we had to do what we had to do, and we scored at the last minute like we did in the playoff game, but I'm happy we did.
Yeah, I remember reading that article in the SanFranPreps.com, and you were saying how you were crying at one moment because you thought your season was over, and then you were crying at the next moment after you scored to know that you guys were still going to keep playing a game, and you eventually won in overtime. Take us through the sequence of that goal, with you setting up Super Mario, as we like to call him.
Super Mario. That's funny. I had three shots before that, and I couldn't pass the ball to him, but I saw the ball was perfectly placed on my left foot, and I saw him wide open, and like you call him Super Mario, he comes out with his little power, his little magic, and he did what he had to do. He scored, and I'm happy he did. That's what we needed.
And I mean, historically, Mission's always been a pretty good soccer powerhouse, and it's taken you guys a while to get back into the championship mix, but you guys are here. Co-champions, I'm sure that's not the ultimate result you wanted, but I'm sure you guys are still pretty happy, right? You get to hoist up the trophy one more time?
Yeah, we're happy, but not that happy. We would have been happier if we would have taken it all, but we got what we got, and like I said to San Fran Preps, it didn't go neither way.
Okay.
So.
And any plans for next year? I mean, this is your final, at least regular season soccer game, or any, you looking at any colleges right now?
I'm focusing in Sonoma State, but if I get anywhere else, it'll be good. So I'm just looking for a scholarship.
Okay.
And Yeah.
Perfect. Well, why don't you hold the trophy for a little bit? We'll get that. That's our other half of our players of the game, Marco Caballero representing Mission. And now we'll bring back Aiden Powers-Riggs, and they'll both hold the trophy up. What a way to go out, folks. Like I said, Lowell and Mission tying in a 1-1 tie through regular through the regulation, and then one overtime, and then a second overtime, and that's why, and then they have no PKs in the San Francisco City section, so that's why both boys holding it up. They both will be co-champions, first time since 1964-65. So congratulations, boys. Enjoy the championship, and enjoy the rest of the offseason. Have fun.
Thanks.
Thank you. All right, guys, those are our players of the game in our player of the game interview, and I'll just take this time to wrap this thing up. It was a very exciting contest that we saw here today between two of the best soccer high schools, the two best soccer teams in the San Francisco City section, between the high schools here of Lowell and Mission. It was a fight to the end, and a championship that is just going to be settled with a tie, first time since 1964 and 65. So, folks, for everyone that was involved in the broadcast, our producer, which was, of course, Zach Farmer, our videographer, Hans Webb, I was the analyst tonight, and a big shout-out goes to our play-by-play guy who had to take off. His name, of course, Stephen Davies. We'd just like to thank you all for joining us and spending your Saturday afternoon with us and listening to this soccer broadcast that was put on by PlayOnSports.com. Stick around. We're going to have championship events and other things following. This is going to be a very busy winter, and we'd like to invite you to stick around and listen and watch all of our broadcasts. I'm Michael Smith signing off, saying have a great weekend. And remember, PlayOnSports.com is your destination for high school sports.
One match away from immortality.
This is a total team effort.